Sports Radio 560 WQAM Miami Fort Lauderdale presents The Neil Rogers Show.
Uh-huh.
To talk to Neil, call 567-0560 toll-free for Dade and Broward or #560 on your cell phone. The opinions of Neil, his guests, callers, or anyone else on the show do not necessarily reflect those of WQAM, Beasley Reed Acquisitions, or the Beasley Broadcast Group. Now, Neil Rogers on Sports Radio 560 QAM.
It's Friday, you bastard.
Come on. Can't wait till 10 in the morning. He's still gonna hit back.
Oh, yeah.
Couldn't tell the worth of art from a hole in his back. But such as wild and woolly, they count on 50 to view it. Cause Dutton Hughes is a dirty job and he's the man to do it.
Oh!
Dutton Hughes is a dirty job. Dutton Hughes is just Jesse's job. He'll put you through the ringer and hang you out to die. He'll kick you out of business cause he's a right-wing guy. He'll break your heart to pieces, but first he's got to go through it. Cause Dutton Hughes is a dirty job and it gets him off to do it. Dutton Hughes is a dirty job. Dutton Hughes is a dirty job. Dutton Hughes is a dirty job. Dutton Hughes is a dirty job and it gets him off to do it. Dutton Hughes.
10:02 at 560 WQM. Happy Friday to you. The lynching is underway in Washington.
Oh!
There you go.
The Patriot.
Henry there. Henry, he's hiding it. Bob Livingston, by the way, screwed around on his wife numerous times. The incoming Speaker of the House, Bob Livingston from Louisiana. That's right. He's not. No plans to resign. He never lied under oath and bada beep, bada boop, bada bop, and et cetera and so on. Although one of his colleagues last night said, which I thought was kind of apropos, he did lie. He took an oath of marriage and lied about that. But hey. That's a whole different feather of another row. What is it? So here's another philanderer up there, Henry Hyde, leading off the lynch mob in Washington today. And in the meantime, we're worried about a bunch of stupid ball games. You know what I'm talking about? Do you follow?
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Now, can that possibly be who you thought it was on that? How come it doesn't say it on there anymore? What happened to that call, George? What happened?
With what?
With the call in Hollywood that you thought was Andy from Hollywood.
Oh, they hung up.
Oh, thank God for that. Wouldn't that be something if it was that jackass
uh-huh.
calling around in the box? Hey, the word yesterday, Andy, was
no.
You understand, in any language just about.
No.
No, no, nine.
No.
Yet.
No, no, no.
That's it. We don't want to talk to you. I don't want to see you. I don't want to hear from you. You make me want to puke, okay? Almost as much, but not quite, as the lynch mob that's going on up right now. You are witnessing, by the way, the dissolution of one of the two major American parties right before your eyes. So maybe in the midst of all of this mayhem and lunacy and all the very, very hysterical crap that's going to go on for several hours today, leading up to a vote either late today or tomorrow, which already it's a foregone conclusion that probably all four of the articles of impeachment will pass, since it's just a little bit on the partisan side. You're watching the dissolution of the Republican Party. They just don't get the message. They refuse to get it. Tom LaHaye's got them all whipped into shape. And they're all obediently saying, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, whatever you say, okay? And here's this fat cow hypocrite standing up there, Henry and his hide,
Gordon.
Leading it off, hawking a China, giving us a big song and a dance about, you know, perjury under oath. And in the meantime, here's a guy that broke up a family that's a philanderer. And in fact, I think that all of them, all 435 members of the House and then all 100 members of the Senate, ought to have to undergo under oath interrogation about every detail of their sex lives that anybody wants to ax. Well, let Larry Flint, just like in that movie, huh? He could be the judge, that's right, just like in a goddamn Larry Flint movie. Since it was Hustler Magazine that outed Bob Livingston, by the way.
Oh!
How's it going, Larry? Bunch of sanctimonious hypocrites, just like I told you. We'll be at the Borders in Plantation, or is that Sunrise, tomorrow on Sunrise Boulevard, out there in West Broward from noon to 2 for our Center 1, which were over not just 100,000, but over 101,000, 101,375.
Oh!
And we thank you profusely, and let's keep that rolling along right through the end of the month. God only knows where we can, wind up with that damn thing, right?
Oh, God.
Only knows. So we're doing swimmingly well, although I will say this, not in the same category with Baldy. Every time you pick up your newspaper, every day of your life, businessmen moved by spirit of giving, says the Herald, Hypinga and Elmore donate a total of $1.35 million. More donations, this time to, Hypinga, his wife Marty, and his sports team, the Dolphins, are donating $1 million. $500,000 to the Jewish Federation of Broward, $250,000 to the Greater Miami Jewish Federation, and $250,000 to the Jewish National Fund. How do you like that? Now, where's the thing about how many trees that they're going to be able to build over there? Like an additional 10,000 trees that they're going to be able to plant in Israel? Something like that. Are you excited about their building 10,000 more trees they're planting in Israel? There you go. And I've always told you there's only one strip of desert that's worth fighting over, and that's Vegas. Not that piece of crap in the over there. So it just goes on and on. Every time Wayne, and of course he's only worth over $1 billion, most of which he's extracting from your pockets, by the way, but nevertheless. And oh yes, I did hear coming in this morning, I heard the amusing commentary about, how the local sports franchises well understand, how much money they're taking out of your pockets. Is that why, Geldy, each and every year in their existence, the Panther ticket prices have gone up? Is that the answer why? So that those tickets in the lower bowl are now a very, very modest $57 a ticket? Yeah. So that you working class people can come out and enjoy that real great the great values on that good food, too, right? That real good, delicious food that's very fairly priced. Am I right?
No.
So there you go. As the suction continues and it never stops, and of course the sports nerds out there, they can't be worried about dropping bombs on Baghdad, about the lynch mob that's going on in Washington right now. We're not concerned about those things. All we're concerned about is who's going to win the game and will they cover the spread. Isn't that the important thing in life?
Uh-huh.
Thank you. Just checking in. Just want to make sure I understand. Pop this thing up. Prod up John Conyers for a second or two in there, and let's see what
our distinguished membership on this side. I'm pleased now to recognize our minority leader, the distinguished gentleman from Missouri, Richard Gephardt, for 3 minutes.
Gentleman from Missouri is recognized.
Did you see him hyperventilating yesterday?
It was wrong. It's wrong.
He's what did he say? 400 times he said it was something like that. Okay, that's enough. So today I thought being the beginning of really moving into the holidays now, it's the 18th of December. Is Chris going out today or do we know in the van?
We don't know.
We don't know yet? I mean, now that we got over $100,000 and he's probably got several phone numbers, I would assume that probably those guys are much more interested in getting laid than they are going out and raising more money for us. But we appreciate their help profusely. That really worked like a charm. And maybe he will be going out today. I have no idea.
I don't know.
Exactly. I couldn't have said it better myself. I could have said... Isn't that what they say in Congress when they do the yeses and the noes? Instead of saying yes, they all say... Which goes to show you how silly it all is. You know, I mean, why can't they at least come into the 18th century? Like when somebody says, you feeling pretty good today? You say, I guess so. It's just stupid. It's just a bunch of bullcrap. And, of course, you all understand what I'm talking about, don't you?
That's the American fucking way.
Right, that's right. It's all a bunch of horse crap. So there we go, but we are dropping the bombs. They're bursting in air, bombing them into the Stone Age. We're hitting the targets. We're doing a spectacular job over there. But we've got to get this thing rolling, don't you understand? We've got to get this thing on because God forbid that thing should drag on for a few days, and then you got your Christmas and your New Year's, and then we got that next House of Representatives, which is going to have five fewer Republicans, as if that would make a difference. And by the way, many of the more right-wing Republicans are going to be out. And also some of the right-wing senators. And that's one thing to keep in mind. Al D'Amato, he's going to be gone. He's been replaced, and others of his ilk have been replaced in the new, even though the numbers are still the same in the Senate, 55-45, some of the more right-wing anti-Clinton people are gone, like Al D'Amato, who just keeps coming to mind over and over again. I just mentioned that for those people who are panicking, those 10 people out there who might care. So we'll just do kind of like a holiday show today. We'll play a lot of stuff, or we could put this stuff on.
So that some of us don't want to be inconvenient.
From Missouri. Come on,
our Rick. Young people are in.
Okay, that's enough. We could pot that up. I'm sure that the all-news station is probably playing that, or else most people are planted right in front of their TV set. So I thought probably we'd present them with an alternative today instead of just potting up this ponderous debate in which we already know exactly what they're going to say depending on which party they're from. But we'll find out. We'll take a little survey on that and find out what the audience wants to hear today. Do they want to hear more of this?
And the decision has been made.
Or do they want to hear more of that?
Neil Rogers God.
The president's well, it's a barely afloat. Old Mrs. Clinton, she's seen better days.
The refs keep on jumping, they must have known something. White water keeps turning, it won't go away.
White water keeps on turning.
Those Arkansas buffoons gonna rat on Hillary.
The white water keeps searching.
Republican snoops gonna dig on Mercy.
White House lawyer keeps on walling.
The paper shredding room is like a hive full of buzzing bees. They keep on shredding all night. They're gonna hide everything. Everything gonna shred everything inside. And they'll be telling those juries that their memories are blurry. They don't recall. Tried to buy some bullshit pizza lunch. Chelsea's mom has written off about 60 grand.
Bogus land, want some bogus land. Da-da-da-da.
Chance to
move the money and now it's gone.
They tried to buy some bullshit pizza lunch. Chelsea's mom has written off about 60 grand.
I want the yes and hell, want some bogus land.
That's okay. Of course, we do understand this is not about sex. We do understand it's not about sex or lying about sex. Because certainly he could have just sat there and said, oh, yeah, she gave the best head I've ever had in my life.
Oh!
There you go. It's one of those catch-22s where they say,
gotcha.
Okay, we got you. And now we know you're going to be forced to lie. And then we're going to say, well, guess what? Lying about that. All of a sudden, we just decided it's an impeachable offense. Is there anybody in their right mind who really believes that?
No.
Of course not. Of course not. Was it a crime against the government, against the people, against anything? Was it?
No.
Of course. Did it have anything to do with the conduct of the government of this country?
No.
Of course not. Everybody knows that. So here we have the Republican Party destructing itself, to which I say,
hey!
They're self-destructing. They're immolating themselves right there in front of your puss. And they can waste the next 5 or 6 months with an impeachment trial in the Senate, which you can bet your last dollar we will go through that. And it'll be even, I'm sure, more ponderous than the O.J. thing. It'll be going. It'll give all these housewives something to do every day anyway, instead of just watching the soaps. And Bob Barker, who's getting really old and white-haired, you'll have something else to do day after day after day after day. And we'll be sitting here. Well, I'll be sitting here talking to myself. Of course, I'm used to that. We'll probably be doing that today anyway, don't you think?
Uh-huh.
I would think so. Because everybody's watching Dick Hebhardt and all these other dicks up there, and they're screaming, and they're yelling, and they're pontificating. They're all pissed off and fired up and foaming at the mouth. And while he's speaking, everybody on one side gets up, and they're giving him a standing ovation. They're all applauding. And then when Henry Hyde was speaking a moment ago, everybody on the other side was getting. And thank God, just remember the very first day when they were holding the House Judiciary Committee hearings, the very first day when John Conyers and Henry Whitehaired Hyde sat there and talked about how there was, we guarantee you that there's not going to be any political partisanship in any of that. Right. No, seriously. Don't we all believe that there wasn't any political partisanship involved in any of this because it's much too important for that? Yeah, we believe it. Here's Doral. Hello.
Well.
Yes, sir.
Hold on, Nelson.
Hey, how are you?
Okay.
This is Mark and Doral calling to say hello.
Yeah.
Where do I start?
Probably at the beginning would be good.
Hold on, I finished chewing. Hold on. I congratulate you for your efforts here on Center One. You always do a good job every year, and not too many people actually do something for the community.
Uh-huh.
And you actually do something.
Yes, I do.
And I found out
in total anonymity, and that's okay with me. By the way, they're down at Cutler Ridge Mall today. They do have a QAM van down there, and Chris is working feverishly to get some more dates. Cutler Ridge Mall, and we'll tell you exactly where in a little while.
And I found something out about myself. I must be a mindless lemming because all I do is keep repeating things that you play on your show from like the 99 yards. And yesterday I found myself going, put the lotion
in the bag.
Yeah. They're doing it all over town, man.
And the oil.
In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if Dick Gebhardt, when he finishes with this speech there, he's going to say,
it puts the lotion in the basket.
And all those right wingers are going to look around like, wow, what was that? They're speaking in code again.
Now, let me ask you, you play this thing, it is so hilarious. It really is. I found it freaky, you know, when you first play, I said, it's stupid. But, you know, the more you listen to it, the funnier it gets.
It's the greatest thing in the history of the human race.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Yeah. Anybody who doesn't get that doesn't have enough IQ to be listening to the show. They should immediately find some other hobby to undertake. They don't. If they don't get it, goodbye.
Hey, Nels, let me ask you something. Nels,
one more time. It's going to be it's already been a long call, but it's going to be a much shorter call.
Okay.
I already changed that name years ago because I don't like it, and only my close personal friends, even they don't call me that. Only my mother, who can be very annoying, only she calls me. Nels.
Okay,
yes.
Uncle Neil. The other day I hadn't heard Phil Henry in a while, and you had played something.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
It was something about Buffalo Bills. He was singing a song.
Oh yeah. That was Mark Booger Belmonte. Don't you remember he used to do that?
I remember
all during the football season, the Booger Belmonte Report every Friday.
Could you do me two favors?
Yeah.
Could you play that and also the Elvis Wishes You the holiday thing?
Okay. Say goodbye.
All right. Goodbye, Nels.
Okay, Nels. Two open lines in Dade, One in Broward. Boy, it's so hot in here, we could fry eggs right on the table. In fact, I could take the rest of my Tyson beef strips and cook them right here on the counter. Boiling in here. Why is that?
I don't know. It's fine in here. I think because of the sun. I left the black stuff from the TV on my windows. But you're in a greenhouse.
Yeah, in a hothouse? Like a hen in a hothouse? Okay, where are we going? Let's take three or four calls today and then get on with it. Let's get on with the good stuff. Oh, by the way, here's Representative Asa Hutchinson from Arkansas.
Mr. Speaker, I support the resolution.
Okay, get him off of there. Okay, sounds like a real redneck to me. Of course, he's from Arkansas. Of course, ain't the president from Arkansas?
Uh-huh.
Well, hey, nobody's perfect. He can't help it. Here's a mobile in Deerfield. Hello. Mobile in Deerfield. Going once. Going twice. Can they get it out of their puss? Can they spit it out? Do they have the ability to speak? No. Okay, two open lines in Broward, one in Dade. Five. Why do people do that? Why do they waste their time on a mobile phone, and then when I go to them, they just sit there like maybe they're thinking about driving or something? Nice going, sir.
Oh!
Congratulations. This man may actually be paying attention to his driving, which he's the one. Because everybody else, every other asshole with a mobile out there, are they paying attention to driving?
No.
Of course not. They're busy having a very important conversation. It's like the people at the hockey games with their cell phones stuck to their ear. God, are we impressed by that?
No.
Man, I am so impressed. Just like I'm impressed by people who drink so many goddamn beers that they stagger out of there as they get ready to get behind the wheel and drive their lovely wife home or fiancé or both. Here's Miami. Hello.
Neil, how you doing?
Great.
Great. Went up there to North Miami yesterday to buy that CD.
Right.
The van was great. I've been listening for about 2 years, and I'm moving back to my home state tomorrow, actually.
And where is that?
It's Philadelphia.
Oh, that's an improvement, except not very good timing.
Yeah.
Why would anybody move back up there in the middle of December?
Yeah, the weather's, you know, the weather's the only thing that I think Philadelphia doesn't have over
mm-hmm.
there. But, what are you going to do? Has the Flyers, though.
Yeah, like I said, pretty marginal game last night, 3-3 tie with Calgary.
I don't know what happened. They scored.
That was pretty weak.
Calgary gets three.
Pretty weak.
I
heard Geldy this morning, as usual, talking about stuff he doesn't know about. Beezer didn't fight anybody, okay? John Sebastian Jaguar, that big kid who's the goalie for Calgary, he went over to try to protect Steve Smith because he don't want to get into fights because he's got a real chronic bad back. So Jaguar comes out there, and he actually goes in there to protect him, and Beezer comes skating the length of the ice, goes up to Jaguar and pushes him, and then, like, runs out of the way like a real pussy.
That was it.
Like, he's a fighter, or who's kidding?
No.
Right.
Yeah.
He's a fighter.
That wasn't a fight. It was just he just pushed.
It's a joke. He just gave him a push and then ran like a pussy.
Yeah, exactly. That CD I bought was it's hilarious. It really is.
Great.
I get to take it back with me. The other thing is that lotion in the basket thing, is there any way you could play that? I had my tape recorder ready. I got to take that back to Philadelphia.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
It's coming.
All right.
And the lotion too. Good luck, pal.
Hey, you
have
too.
A great life and thanks for your help. There he goes. He's moving back to Philadelphia.
Oh!
A real city with some real people in it. Nasty sports fans, though, probably the worst in America, I would say. I don't think there's anybody else. Some of the New York fans are pretty obnoxious, too. But Philadelphia, all their sports fans, they blow, man. They boo and they scream and they holler. And you could hit a home run like 9 times in a row, and the 10th time you strike out, they're going to boo your ass right off the field because they're obnoxious. 5670560, pound 560 on a mobile one line. Let's see what Asa's got to. Okay, that's enough. Cannot stand rednecks in Congress. I mean, people that are so obviously rednecky. Rednecks and bubbleheads like Mary Bono. Bubbleheads. Bubbleheaded philanderers. There's another one. We got Mary Bono. Now we got Bob Livingston by the short hairs. I like the way he says he has had several infidelities, okay? And then he tries to narrow it down. One moment, please. I have on occasion strayed from my marriage, and doing so nearly cost me my marriage and family. Then he says, this chapter was a small but painful part of the past in an otherwise wonderful marriage of 33 years. This chapter. See, you see how people conveniently, they kind of change things as they go along? First he starts out by saying he's been screwing around with a whole bunch of broads. God only, he can't even keep track so many. But then he talks about this chapter in his life. Just like Henry Hyde was a young man sowing his wild oats. He was only 41 years old when he screwed around with this broad and lied through his teeth and said that he wasn't married and broke up this guy's marriage who lives in Weston. That's all it's all about. It is absolutely nobody's got. In fact, Henry Hart started out by saying that people's sexual lives is nobody else's goddamn business, and this is all that it's about. And then they cornered Bubba in there, and they put him in a position where there's no way. Just put yourself in that position. You're the president of a country, no matter what country it is, and you're going to go under oath, and they're going to ask you embarrassing personal questions about did you get blowjobs, and is that your semen on a blue dress, and et cetera, and so on, and was it good, and was it bad? What are you going to say?
No.
That's right. Guaranteed. Oh, but he lied under oath to come into... Yeah, big deal, okay? Like they say, so what? It's the so what defense. And guess what I say? So what?
Oh!
But don't confuse these fascists with the truth, man, because the lynching is well underway. And it will go on for hours and hours and hours. And then they'll be voting later on, either today or tomorrow. And then, like I said, for months and months and months, you're going to have a lynching on the air. See, the one thing about lynch mobs, they don't wait. That's why they can't wait for a couple of days for the bombing in Iraq for that all to, be over with. Lynch mobs don't wait. When they start hyperventilating and foaming at the mouth, they want they smell it. They taste that blood, and they want it right now. Like Dracula, he don't wait. As soon as he smells that blood, he's got his teeth in your thing. Boy, it's just boiling in here.
I'll go fix it.
26, how many times have I complained about it boiling in here? Like maybe three times in the last year, and usually from those pain in the ass TV people. Oh, Barry Jackass, by the way, says Whammy is off to a great start. Yeah, because they got the Marlins. Barry, you are, Hank is right about you. You're not even worth the space you take up on the planet or the air that you're breathing. You're such a pusillanimous putz, Barry. Whammy, off to a great start, yeah. By the way, how many games the Heat won so far?
It's Friday, you bastard.
Right. Well, Buffalo has a football team, the greatest in the land. And everybody thinks they're great because they really are. The Buffalo Bills are the number one. See what I mean? So just sing a little.
When you say Miami.
When you say Buffalo. And here's that. Buffalo Bills. Buffalo Bills. They're the greatest team in the history of the human race. They're the Buffalo Bills. They're the greatest thing since sliced bread and canned beer. Yeah, there you go. And you jazz up that redneck stuff. They listen to that banjo. Holy sweet God, listen to that. When you say Buffalo Bills, it don't sound so rednecky, do it. Everybody sing along now. Are you Bill fans? Here we go. Well, the Buffalo Bills are the best team. They have the best record over the last 5 years. And they went to the Super Bowl 4 times, which is more than I can say for this scum-sucking fish. And they're the greatest, because I really like their uniforms. They sure as hell beat the heck out of having a fish on the helmet, because they're the Buffalo Bills.
Are you sure?
The best football team what I ever seen in the history of my life. They are the Buffalo Bills. The Buffalo Bills. The home of Jim Kelly, the greatest quarterback in the league. Yeah, everybody, the Buffalo Bills. They're the Buffalo Bills. And they've been around longer than the stinking rotten fish. Well, they're the Buffalo Bills. Buffalo Bills. What would you rather have as a pet, a buffalo or a fish?
Okay, it's 10:32 at 560 WQM. By the way, you're welcome. So anyway, somebody faxes me. Did you look at this thing? With the definitions of censure and impeach, and then underneath it they've written, should Clinton be tried in the Senate and found guilty, what will the results then be? What will the results then be? As the umpire says at first base when the throw beats you by 15 feet, you're out. That's the results will be. Only the interesting part of this whole thing is maybe they're not thinking too clearly. Well, obviously not, because, you know, when you're rabid and you start foaming, obviously you've lost your ability to think clearly. But after February, I'm pretty sure it's after February 1 or February something, at that point, if Gore became president, if Clinton were impeached by and convicted in the Senate, removed from office, and Gore becomes president, he can still serve two full terms. If Clinton were to resign tomorrow, the law says that he can't do that. He could only serve one full term plus the remainder of this term. But if it's after February, I do believe, and certainly a Senate trial is going to take longer. It won't be over by February, will it?
No.
Of course not. So, like I said, the Republican Party is like kind of making way for more reasonable people. And to that we say, thank you, even if it's only by accident, even if you have taken leave of your senses. Here's Fort Myers. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
My name is John. Can I give us a sensible Republican, please? I am completely disgusted by what my party's doing to Bill Clinton. Now, I'm no fan of Bill Clinton. I'm a Clinton freak. I hate what he's done to my people, to my friends. But I think it's an absolute disgrace. I think it might be the worst thing to happen to this country since Watergate, maybe even Vietnam.
What do you mean since Watergate? I think it's the worst thing that ever happened to this country.
The worst thing ever?
Yes.
Since Vietnam? That's maybe going a little bit far. But one question.
Next to the Civil War, I would say, was the worst thing that ever happened.
Okay, I can accept that. One question. Vietnam, yes. What? Just one question. Do you think that the presence of our planes...
Or the Braves losing the playoffs, yes?
Well, that was important. Well, hell. Let's see, do you think the presence of our planes and missiles over Iraq are directly related to the presence of nerve endings in Bill Clinton's penis?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Whatever that meant. Okay, so in other words, he's very upset with his party, but he's talking about Bill Clinton's penis again, okay? I mean, didn't you hear the tapes when Monica said...
You call that a penis?
I mean, what's wrong with you, sir? You're just not paying attention. Like most of your cohorts, you're too blinded by the blight. Isn't that what Manfred Mann said? Something about blinded by the blight? And I don't want to hear about, what's his name, because he makes me sick to my stomach. That also recorded that, and, We have an open line in Dade and one in Broward. 5670560, pound 560 on the Springsteen line. What is this story? It goes to show you anybody can be a big success, okay? You can scream and you can wail. You couldn't sing your right out of a paper sack, and you're going to make millions of dollars for it. I would say he's probably got less talent than even Mickey Rourke. Okay, here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
That's great. I've been listening to you for a year now since you came on 560. You're the best thing on that.
Best goddamn thing
best
on this
thing
station.
On that channel.
Here we got bombs on Iraq. We got the president and impeachment debate going on in the House of Representatives, and they're talking about ball games here today. And has Danny Marino got a bigger penis than Jimmy Johnson? Okay. I mean, what the hell? Who cares about his Johnson?
Right. those two new CDs are excellent. I picked them up the other day at Borden.
Thank you.
I want to know if you could play that Baghdad song for me.
I'll work on it. Have
Next
a great holiday. Okay, see ya. Okay, the bagpipe. We have an open line, and keep these in mind, okay? I'll try to remember them, and if not, open line at Broward 1 and Dade. And don't forget, Chris is out there with a QAM van down by the Cutler Ridge Mall. We'll find the exact location for you. Do we know the exact location yet? Of course not, because he'll let us know when he gets there. He'll find a good spot where all the hot chicks are, and then we'll raise some more money today. Let me say it again, $101,375. Nice check from Wayne Arnold, by the way. Thank you, Wayne.
Oh!
Even if you are confused and think that you're a political expert. Poor Wayne. Wayne is a food expert. He knows his Royal Castle burgers and his White Hots. He's a food expert. Just look at him. It's obvious he's eaten a meal or two in his time. You know what I'm talking about? I'm sure you do. But he wants to be a political curmudgeon. And the thing about Wayne is that he spreads it around. He loves Ted Kennedy. He loves Jeb Bush. He loved Lawton Childs. He wrote a moving piece about Lawton Childs in the Daily, whatever that is, fish wrapper. Wayne just, he likes everybody. Here's North Miami. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, three things. Whammy reminds me of the Titanic. You know, like they said, it wouldn't sink, and what happened to
mm-hmm.
it.
Right.
And then you got, I was watching Henry High with his long, drooling speech.
He was drooling a lot, yeah.
Oh,
probably
my God.
Probably thinking about that bitch.
Did you see it dripping down on the paper?
And the drool, too, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
He had to have his
aide there, his assistant, come over and wipe him off every couple of minutes.
What an asshole.
And his mouth, too, yeah.
Yeah, but, you know, that is really ridiculous and embarrassing. And then
all these philanderers up there, the president got blowjobs with this young bimbo who went there to screw around, who, you know, who told all of her friends, who's nothing but a blabbing Jap, told all her friends she went there with a presidential knee pad, who dressed provocatively, who seduced him because he's married
it.
To an ice princess that he hasn't screwed in 14 years, and now because he refused to say, oh, yeah, I screwed around, like nobody in the world would say it anyway, now it's impeachable and it's perjury and he's violated his oath under the Constitution and all this serious crap, like somebody really believes this that's got a brain.
Hey, Neil, one more thing.
And, of course, thank God Newt Gingrich never lied before Congress.
Oh,
yes.
No, he wouldn't do that.
No.
No.
Got
one more
slap
thing.
On the limp wrist, yes.
One more thing. All those guys who were calling a few days ago with these names, most of those guys, they were just basically picking on black people, and that's all they were doing.
Yeah.
So that wasn't fair.
Okay, well, let's pick on, how about Yitzhak? Let's pick on some Jews today. Have a great day, pal.
Thanks, Bill.
Yeah, let's pick on some Jewish names today. Then we'll pick on some Latino names on Monday. We want to spread it around. Although it is true that most of the bizarre names are Schwartz names. I don't know why that is. It's because, again, of that propaganda. They've been convinced that it has something to do with African names. And like I said, Nelson Mandela is a perfectly reasonable-sounding name to me. If Nelson's good enough for me, it's certainly good enough for any Schwarzer out there, including Nelson Mandela. We have two open lines in Dade, 5670560. It's all Request Friday. It's the holidays. Everybody's in the spirit. Here's Representative Menendez from New Jersey, by the way.
It's a way to protect our government and our citizens.
That's a good Jewish name for you. Get him off of there, okay? Even they're banging a gavel. Like, quit hocking a Chinook already, you crazy spit bastard. That's what they're saying.
I like peace and quiet, and I don't need to listen to Barney Frank ranging in my ear because I made a few bucks off a book I worked on.
This is Debbie.
Yeah, hi, Debbie. I'm interested in getting some operations done.
Okay.
And some body contouring and some liposuction.
Mm-hmm.
And I was wondering if you get some tummy tuck and lip augmentation, cosmetic breast surgery, facelift, all of these things.
Mm-hmm.
And I was wondering...
What would you like to start with?
Well, I need to get everything done. Probably the first thing I'd like to have removed is my thing.
Okay, we don't do that.
No. Could you do breast implants, though?
It can be done, but I don't know if they would do it right away.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Mm-hmm.
How much?
$5,000.
Excellent. I'd like to have my skin resurfaced, too.
Mm-hmm.
Laser surgery.
Mm-hmm.
Have the lambs stopped crying yet, Mommy?
Excuse me?
Don't hurt Mommy's little baby. It puts the lotion in the basket. I'd like to get the liposuction that I saw on TV.
Okay.
Can you make me look more like a woman?
Well, we'll have to see you first, and then upon looking at you, we can tell you that when we see you.
Should I wear my skin suit made of body parts, Mommy?
If you'd like to.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Would you like to make an appointment?
Yes.
Okay, there is a $100 consultation fee.
That's fine.
Okay. Okay,
My name is Buffalo Bill.
Okay, let me get a little information from you, okay?
Puts the lotion in the basket.
I understand.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Do you want to come in for a consultation for
advice? It puts the lotion in the basket.
Okay. Would you like to make an appointment or do you want to call me back?
It puts the lotion in the basket.
I understand.
I've got my skin suit nipple necklace.
Bill.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
I understand that. Would you like to
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Would you like to make an appointment?
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Okay, I will talk to you in the trim, okay?
It puts the lotion in the basket. Hello?
Okay, 1046 at 560 WQAM. So if you thought that was funny, another facts today. This man, seriously, where do we find these people? Like I told you before, every time we get rid of one, we find another lunatic to take its place. Neil, let's get the record straight now. I did not call, fax, or bother you today. I want to thank you for starting your show and ripping me for no reason. Maybe it'll be better for you and I to kiss and make up. You know something? That's the most revolting thing. I would rather lick Al Goldstein's rectum, okay, than kiss and make up with Andy. I'd rather be dead than get anywhere near Al Goldstein's rectum. You asked me not to come over and to you at the hockey games, and I stopped. You asked me not to call, and I stopped. Thank God! Greg and I are leaving you alone. Oh, Greg and I. How do you like that? Like they're joined at the hip. Are leaving you alone and wish the same from you. I still love you, Andy. P.S. Cynthia said she'll see you on Saturday night, not me. Well, Cynthia, you're a sweetheart. You're okay, but stay the hell away, okay? Do I want to see Cynthia?
No.
Do I want to see Andy?
No.
Do we want ever another fact?
No.
Another phone
no.
call? Another message?
No.
Another psychotic piece of behavior?
No.
No, you have nothing to say. You have nothing to contribute. You're a bubblehead. You're a simpleton. Does anybody in the world want to speak to you?
No.
Maybe Cynthia needs a pair of glasses, okay? God, maybe she just feels sorry for you. You're pathetic. You're subhuman. Here's a fact that says, what the hell is that guy Andy's problem? Does he have too much time on his hands?
Uh-huh.
Does he have a life?
No.
We're even getting faxes about what an asshole he is now. Oh, God. Every time we get rid of one or they move away or somebody gets them with a butterfly net and sticks them far away from us so they can't bother us anymore, we get another one to replace them. Every single time. There's no shortage of radio misfits out there. That much I guarantee you. That's one thing I've learned over the last 200 years. There is no shortage of chronic radio misfits. Like that story he was telling me at the game last week before I realized who it was about how he called this place to complain that he couldn't hear the station inside the Mac Arena. Oh, by the way, we have they're a little upset that I keep calling it that, and baseball season is long over with. Nobody cares about Mac McGuire anymore. So let's call it by their real name, okay? The National Colorectal Center. But anyway, he comes over to me and he's telling me about how he called here. And he makes up this story about, well, you know, when you call QAM, you try to get through and you get all these extensions, Andrew Ash in the Woods and all these other people that don't even work. He's telling me this whole big song and dance about how he called here to try to get a hold of the engineer. And I told him, our engineer, who's a good guy, but got 50 million different projects that he's got to do all by himself, has got more important things than to talk on the phone to some pudwacker like you about how come you can't pick up the station in the arena. In addition to which, if you're such a hockey fan, if you know anything about the sport, why would you want to listen to Christina Moore or anybody else for that matter while you're watching a game? See, one thing I'll tell you right now, and that is that people who wear headsets to ball games don't know what the hell it's all about. When I used to go to the Dolphin games all those years, there were people in front of me, and they got their Walkman on. They got, you know, for what? Why? Right on the 50-yard line there. These are people who had the best seats in the house, including me. What the hell do you need a headset for? It's right there in front of your face. And the same thing at hockey games. There are these people with their headsets on, like Christina Moore is going to impart some educational thing, something that will enlighten them about the game that's going on. I mean, if you're going to learn something from him, then you know nothing. So like I said, I'm going to start selling headsets outside the National Colorectal Center because obviously most of those people know nothing about the game, which is why they're doing the wave. And they're going, Stewie. Yeah, right. He don't play for us anymore. Oh, don't confuse us. Here's a Homestead. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
You've got me in stitches. What a bit. That was funny.
Yeah.
The lotion in the basket. Anyway.
Yes, sir.
I'm real happy this morning. Now, we finally signed Ziggy as in Toppy.
We,
the Islanders. I'm
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Picked
them
up for...
How come that got so little publicity? They mentioned that during the game last night, during the Philly-Calgary game, and I didn't even realize it.
Well, I was watching that
game. Little tiny piece in the paper this morning in the local papers here, which give us no hockey coverage, and if you have a magnifying glass, you'll see that.
That's why I've got a DSS. I was watching the Philly-Calgary game, and then I switched over to the late game on Spot Sports Channel New York, and they were talking about it a little bit, but... I tell you, one gift for us has been...
They still aren't going to make the playoffs. Still aren't going to make the playoffs. No chance.
We'll see what happens. But anyway, Kenny Johnson, I mean, this guy is like God, and nobody talks about him. Great defenseman.
You can thank the Maple Leafs for that.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome.
You guys had him.
And of course, now we got Kirk Muller here, so...
Yeah, exile
what comes around goes around. Okay, well, good luck to you, pal. You'll need it. Get out of here. Two open lines in Dade, one in Broward. We got Ziggy Palfy. We, the Islanders. Are there any Islander fans?
No.
Of course not. 5670560, #560 on a Mobile One line. We got more people in this building right now than show up at those Islander games, 10 or 12. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
All, thank you for years of entertainment.
Oh, there's that Representative George Geekus from Pennsylvania, that Nazi summer. Yeah, get that off of there, that geek. Go ahead, sir. Truth in packaging. He's a geekus.
I wanted to get your take, Neil.
He's a
geekus. What in God's name, or how in God's name?
What in...
Neil, God!
Yeah, how in whose name did do the Republicans possibly think they're going to get reelected? Or don't they realize that this is going to hurt them in the election process?
No.
I mean,
No, they're not thinking rationally. They're all being manipulated by Tom DeLay and the right-wing extremists in their party. They've been whipped into shape. They've been threatened. They've been intimidated. You notice how in the last
by members of their own party,
they've all conveniently goose-stepped right into line. Each and every one of the so-called moderates, they've goose-stepped right into line. And even that fascist Bob Novak on CNN last night was saying this wouldn't be the first time that the so-called moderate wing of the Republican Party is shocked and surprised and let everybody down, even though he was saying it from a different perspective. But nevertheless, he's right.
You think they just don't
moderate
give a crap
Republican
because
is
some
an
of them
oxymoron
are
in America these days, sir. There is no more moderate Republican Party. It's the party of Pat Robertson, Jerry Falwell, Richard Viggory, all these lunatics. That's what it is.
Back in the old days,
Jerry
they
Bauer,
something like
Papa
this
Bauer.
Under the rug, and now all of
Hank
a sudden
Bauer.
It's a major issue.
Right.
Well, anyways, Neil, have a great weekend. Just a shameless
Can you imagine? I don't know if you're old enough, but can you imagine them taking President Kennedy and putting him on a witness stand and saying, "Have you been screwing around with Marilyn Monroe and with that bitch Sam Giancana's girlfriend and all these other bimbos in the White House?" He would have called out the CIA and had them all blown away.
Yeah, he wouldn't. They wouldn't have time for that kind of meeting.
He would have sent
them
all to goddamn Cuba is what he would have done for another Bay of Pigs invasion.
Neil, bowel moves, please.
Okay.
Thanks, man.
Okay, here's a preview. Okay, we have two open lines in Dade 2 in Broward. I keep asking, should we put this stuff on? We got the pot is working today, okay? When the pot is working, smoke it. But evidently, they really want to hear a show today. I don't know, because I know we're fighting uphill today. Because, you know, America's mesmerized. They're sitting there wide like they're going to hear these people saying something new. I mean, is that a joke or what?
Uh-huh.
They're going to hear these guys saying something new they haven't said over and over and over again, making all these impassioned, hysterical speeches. It's a waste of time. They should have limited the debate to 10 minutes and gone on with the vote, and then they could have gone out and played golf or something for crying out loud or got laid. Because this is just another exercise, just like the other hearings were the last 2-3 weeks, just another exercise. It's all window dressing. It's a sideshow they're putting on for you. They've already got the votes, and they know it. So what the hell's the point of wasting all this time and acting duly outraged and indignant? One call left on the board. Okay, like I said, here's Aventura. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yes, did you hear that congressman from Mississippi's comments last night about the bombing of Iraq?
No.
He said that President Clinton should be ashamed of himself for doing this in the middle of Advent and in the on the eve of the birth of our Lord and Savior.
Mm-hmm.
And I almost threw my menorah.
And don't forget the ram-a-lum and ding dong.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hey, in closing.
Yeah.
Dr. Lecter.
Okay, thanks, Jody. Sounded like Jody. Well, she's almost dead, Butch, or maybe a little bit. We have two open lines in Dade 2 in Broward. 5670560 #560 on the AT&T wireless line. They want us just to. Here's Representative Ed Bryant, good old Republican from Tennessee, who says.
Monica Lewinsky.
Okay, that's enough. Well, didn't they predict this? That's all we're going to be hearing now. Monica Lewinsky, Linda Tripp, Lucien Goldberg, Monica Lewinsky. Jesus Christ. Couldn't believe it. You could see Barney Frank mumble under his breath. As soon as he said Monica Lewinsky, Barney was mumbling.
That fucking bitch.
Yeah. He was lisping it. 5 minutes before the hour here on 560 WQM, the Hank Goldberg Show at 2. We got the Bookster at 6. Ed Kaplan at 10 o'clock tonight. We'll have the morning line odds on impeachment.
The Neil Rogers Show, now on 560 WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
Get the Hoover out the moon, man.
You turd. I was a little too stuck, had to lose a few pounds. Pants too tight, jeans busted out. Just had a big burrito with meat and rice. Salsa on top with some extra spice. Lots of extra spice. Out there in the bathroom where the air gets heavy. Sat on a cold seat, thought I was ready. Breaking out crosswords and reading the news. Working on a bowel move. Trying to move some back up drive through food. Working on a bowel move. And it was taking time. I was up last night trying to make some thunder.
How long would it take? I sat and wondered. Started reading a magazine from 1962. And I'm waiting on a foul move. Cause I'm all bound up from cheese that's turned to glue. Praying for a foul move. I'm out of paper again. Foul move. For a foul move. I wanna remember, I wanna remember, I wanna remember. I should've brought my camera. Oh, oh. Ooh, ooh. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah.
By the way, they just drafted Article Number 5. The president had some very, very messy diarrhea in the White House and splattered the presidential seat. Okay, there's Article Number 5. Yeah, he soiled the seat of the presidency. Yeah, it just goes on and on. It is so patently ridiculous on the face of it that even a 10-year-old child can look at this thing and say, what a bunch of garbage this is. What kind of
crap
is this going on here? A bunch of supposed intelligent adults here arguing over the president lied about getting a few blowjobs from some bimbo with their presidential knee pads, with their scumbag mother that saved the dress so they could, make a fortune from it, with that stain on it. Let me say it again. If there was no dress, we wouldn't be in this mess. Make no mistake about that right now. That's what Johnny Cochran said on Larry King the other night. If it weren't for that goddamn dress, we wouldn't be in this mess. And Larry said, hey, you want to come back on the show again?
No.
He said, no. He said, you've been, haven't sucked my ass enough, Larry. 5670560. I think we ought to put this on, okay? Here's some dark complexion guy.
50 million people elected Bill Clinton as our president.
This guy can barely
in spite of his
speak,
problems,
but
his shortcomings, and his failures.
His shortcomings.
They, the people,
that's
elected
the, that,
Bill
that's
Clinton.
That's the problem. That's why I wound up on
the
dress.
It was
a shortcoming.
And they want him to remain the president of the United States.
Okay, get him off of there, okay? He's a good guy, but he can't speak. He's another one of your representatives from Georgia, no less, okay? He's a good guy. A little on the dark complexion side. 5670560, very little interest in this show today. They're all watching this crap. We have, what are we talking to, about 20, 30 people? And so where did Chris wind up? Is he down there yet or what?
I think they're en route.
Oh, they're en route? Probably picking up a few strays on the way to the Cutler Ridge Mall. You'll be amazed at how much we're going to raise there for Center One today, down somewhere in that Cutler Ridge Mall area. That's where our audience in Dade County is, in Cutler Ridge.
Oh!
Are they in Hialeah?
No.
Are they in Little Havana?
No.
Are they in Kendall?
No.
Not out. They sure are not in Kendall. I wonder what that was all about. In fact, let me take a look at the latest. Look at Boca. That's right. One day next week, if we can con him into continuing to do this right through the end of the year, we should send Chris's ass up to Boca, maybe the rest of them, too. Boca was the number one border store last week.
Oh!
Let's hear it for Boca, $1,980 last week. Just beating out Plantation, where we'll be tomorrow, by the way, from noon to 2, in that Plantation store on Sunrise Boulevard out west. 1980 to 1840. Followed by Boynton Beach. The Palm Beach people are coming through, baby.
Oh.
There you go. We don't hear from them, but they're out there. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
Hypocrite Hyde mentioned the rule of law maybe 25 times.
Yeah.
I'm wondering, did he mean the German rule of law that slaughtered 5 million people?
12 million. Yeah.
Okay. Or the church rule of law that killed the most people during the Crusade,
right?
Or the Russian rule of law, or the British rule of law that our founding fathers threw out the window and overthrew during our revolution?
Yeah,
wasn't the rule of law? We are
okay. Well, listen, I'll tell you what. Go ask him and let me know what his answer was. Okay, we have one line lit up on the board, and that's it. I think we're just going to play stuff the rest of the day. These people have no interest in speaking to me. Let's play some good holiday stuff, okay? My favorite Christmas song of all time. It's short, it's sweet.
Merry Christmas, and here comes this time each year.
So what about the Beach Boys Museum? When the hell is that open?
Well, way up north where the air gets cold, there's a tale about Christmas that you've all been told.
Oh!
In a real famous cat, all dressed up in dress, and he spends the whole year working out in his sled. It's a little Christmas. It's a little Christmas. Just a little Christmas.
I just had Hillary on there, and she said it's time to cut the crap because...
It puts the lotion in the basket.
That's what she said. Boy, they're starting that drilling again out there today. Man, it makes us feel like we're right in the office with our dental paper pushers across the hall, whom we love dearly, by the way. They're great. We thank them again for their nice contribution to Center One. That was really over and above the call of duty. And I actually am going to send them something, but I'll wait till after the new year. Maybe some false teeth. Here's a mobile in Boca. Hello.
Hey, where is the borders here in Boca?
I have no idea.
Because I'm here, and I'm only here in business, and I want to stop by there on my way out.
But we'll find out for you. Just keep listening. I'll find out for you in a matter of moments.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
And God bless you. Okay, Boca, our number one store, baby, for borders last week. That's a shocker. Was there anybody in this audience that would have ever guessed Boca?
No.
Beats out everybody else? By the way, the Grove is missing from here. We don't have any report from the Grove, probably with good reason why. Do we know where the borders is in Boca, isn't it, on Glades and somewhere?
I don't know.
I don't know. But somebody will call and tell us, okay? Actually, it would have been nice if we would have had the addresses for each of these on here on this list.
Hey.
I know. Now, that's right. You're starting to complain too much, mister. You're complaining too goddamn much, you miserable bastard. Nitpicking over details.
The van is there.
The van is at Cutler Ridge Mall?
Actually, at the Publix, 3 or 4 blocks south of the Cutler Ridge Mall, on the east side of US 1 on 113th Avenue.
At the Publix, 113th Ave, Southwest, obviously.
Glades and 441 is the...
That's what I said, Glades and 441. I knew the Glades part, and we got the 441. Thank you so much. Glades and 441 in Boca is where you'll find your borders up there. That's our award-winning store, by the way.
Oh!
All right! That's where all the Yidlach are, up there in Boca. That's why we're doing so great up there. So the QAM van today to raise a lot more money for Center One is at the Publix 3 blocks south of Cutler Ridge Mall, southwest 103rd, is on the southwest side of what? Say that again.
Say what now?
The Publix is 3 blocks
three
south.
3 or 4 blocks south
of the Cutler Ridge Mall, right.
On the east side.
On the east side of the of Dixie Highway?
On US 1 and 113th Avenue.
East side of US 1 and 113th Avenue, the Publix. In the parking lot there, you'll see the QAM van. You'll see Chris, who's busy with his little notepad, taking down numbers.
Across the street from Big Jim's Barbecue, where they're trying
right
to
across the street from Big Jim's Barbecue, where they're trying to suck up some free food.
Spread 'em and say cheese.
Oh. Okay. Okay, 11:14 at 560 WQM. Merry Christmas, happy Chinooka, and happy impeachment. There's Bob Barr, that little Nazi who never met a fascist that he didn't like. Boy, he is just human scum would be a compliment to him, you know? Scum would be a major what?
They got 15 cars there already with just one mention.
I told you, Cutler Ridge is where the audience is at. Haven't I been telling you that? I said, if we're going to go to Dade County, why couldn't we go down to Cutler Ridge like that tremendous appearance we had at Cutler Ridge Mall 2 years ago, the last time we did this? They were lined up from here to goddamn Key West down there in Cutler Ridge. They were lined up all the way to goddamn Venezuela. What?
Biggest appearance of that year.
Right. Cutler Ridge, that's where they are. See, Coral Springs was great. I told you. I don't want to say I told you. Smoke, like I'm a, and one day next week we'll do Boca. They'll be lined up all the way to goddamn Jacksonville in Boca. So anyway, I got a couple of Panther tickets to give away here. Which we're not doing any more giveaways. And by the way, you notice how much better things have been going since we stopped doing the giveaways?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. I mean, markedly better. We've actually had a show here virtually every day since I stopped doing that crap. Since we stopped wasting your time with all those freeloading bastards. But Greg Reed just came down here and put these in my hand. A pair for tomorrow night's game, the Panthers and the Edmonton Oilers. And by the way, there's no you in Edmonton. I don't want to start nitpicking with those idiots at the arena. At the National Correctional Center. I don't want to start nitpicking with them, but there's no you in Edmonton. I just mentioned that in passing. These are front row, section 133, row 1, seats 9 and 10, and the yellow preferred parking pass for somebody that wants to go to that game tomorrow night and sit right there. They can press their nose right up against the glass, and they can see those Edmonton Oilers. Is there anybody we want to see on the Edmonton Oilers? Trying to think if there's anybody on Edmonton Oilers that I want to see up close. No, not really. Not since they traded Jason Arnott to New Jersey. I don't think I want to sit down there and put my nose right up against the glass because Ray Whitney would be embarrassed. By the way, nice going, Ray.
Oh!
Scores the winning goal the other night in that game against Pittsburgh. And the Sun Sentinel, somebody ought to tell them, by the way, that the 12th and the 16th of December are already gone. They put the calendar in there on the sports page for the remainder of December, and they've got it like a cutoff this weekend. And they've got games listed in there that already have been played. But, hey, now you're nitpicking again. What? See, look at this. I'm giving tickets away to some deserving person out there, and we still got most of the lines open. I'm talking to myself today. I'm not going to lie about it.
They're calling for the tickets.
Yeah, and they think that you're going to give them to them?
Yes.
George don't have any tickets, okay? I have the tickets. I got them in my hand right now and the parking pass, too. George has got no power to give you any goddamn tickets. He may give you a speeding ticket. He may write you a ticket for being an annoying caller. That's what we're going to start doing, by the way. We've been empowered by the local law enforcement authorities to start writing tickets. We're going to trace the call. We have Southern Bell cooperating with us on this. We're going to start writing tickets out. And if you think you pay a lot for speeding tickets, wait to the minimum $500 for asshole callers on the phone. But I got a pair of tickets right in the front row there, and I still got two open lines in Dade County. 567-0560, Tom 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Because I'm talking to myself, because we got this speechman thing going on up there.
From?
Right. From hunger. That's where it is, from hunger. From Uranus.
120.
120 what?
Is the total down there.
Don't confuse me with too many numbers, okay, mister? 120 already down there in Cutler Ridge, and we got them lined up. That's, let me tell you again, Publix. Down there at Southwest 113th and US 1, on the east side of US 1, right across from, what was it, Jim Bob's Wieners and Beer, what was it? Right across from some joint. And maybe you'll find one of those there, too. In fact, if Chris is in the van, you probably will find one of those in there. And a joint, too. You know what I'm talking about? Do you?
Yeah, I'm on.
Okay. Well, I'm a little slow today because I'm under a lot of stress. I'm trying to do a show. I'm talking to myself. Trying to do a show here against the guy. There's Representative Sam and his Johnson, Republican from Texas. And of course, you don't have to doubt what they're saying. You don't have to even read their lips. Thank God there's no partisanship in any of this, okay? So, just a tremendous exercise. They're spending millions of dollars more of our time. In the meantime, finally, better late than ever, we're over there bombing the goddamn Saddam people into the Stone Age, obliterating it. Look what a great job they're doing with those hits, too, by the way. You look at those before and after pictures that they're giving us. Like before, there were all these big buildings and these big palaces, and now there's like rubble. Barney Rubble is over there with a bad look on his puss. And that Dutch guy, that Dutch pilot is flying over singing the Flintstones. But these people are all sitting there glued to it because, well, you know, it's the American effing way. We're supposed to be, we're supposed to be sitting there glued to this crap. Like we're going to learn something from this today? Like there's going to be some elucidation from this process? From this bullcrap? Oh, there's Henry Hyde again. Probably got naked pictures in his pocket. In fact, I think he was the one who discovered that Hustler article about Bob Livingston reading his latest issue. I think he was the one that held that Hustler up at the hockey game the other night. Nice going, Henry.
Oh!
He ain't hiding it anymore. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Neil, how you doing?
Great.
Great show. First of all, Neil, have you heard, I don't know if you talked about this, the Burlington Coat Factory thing?
The Burlington Coat Factory thing?
Yeah, did you hear about it?
That China article I was on, the piece that was on about the dogs?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm a dog lover myself.
Yeah.
And you know what? I wouldn't condemn these people for living their life the way they want to. But two things, man. First of all, here in the U.S., when we want to eat something or whatever, we kill it first, and then we eat it, or we wear it. But you should see what they do to these animals, man. I mean,
I didn't watch that piece. It would have made me sick to my stomach to see it.
I mean, they amputate these animals, let them walk around, die, whatever, or they skin them alive, you know.
And then these are the Chinese?
Actually,
that are so upset about us bombing
Laundry
heads, yeah.
Who cares? I mean, actually, I'm a Republican, but actually Clinton would be my favorite if he bombed China and France, by the way. But
that's next week.
I sure hope so. But you know, and the other thing, and the other thing is, Neil, I mean, it's the other thing about this is that, like I said, I don't mind what they do over there, but it made its way over here to the U.S. You know, and this type of crap, man. You know, jeez, and you know, all that suffering has to do with the philosophy of suffering over there in the
Orient. Well, of course, they eat cat over there. And what red-blooded American guy doesn't like to eat? Okay, here's Charles Schumer, by the way.
Rare
is, just beat Al D'Amato and is our new senator starting after the first of the year.
Against the overwhelming will of the American people.
Okay, that's enough. Like I said, you already know what each and every one of them is going to say. I mean, they couch it a little bit different. We know what they're going to say. We know who are the good guys. We know who are the Nazis. And that's it. That's where it's at. There is absolutely no nonpartisanship involved, none whatsoever. There's no reason, there's no compromise, there's no rationality, there's no peace on earth, goodwill toward men, women, children, dogs, anybody else. It's just a bunch of horse crap. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
that's all it is. And, of course, the media sit back and they present this, like I've said before, very dutifully. And Frank Sesno on CNN sits there with that serious look on his eyes, the same guy who talked about how disgusting it was that we had to hear all the juicy details and the president getting blowjobs and the semen stain on his dress, et cetera, and so on. Like Frank Sesno never got a semen stain on his dress, right? Who the hell is he kidding? They're all screwing around. They all lie about it. They all do their best to cover up their tracks, okay? And if they get caught with their pants down, they're going to lie about it then till the very last minute because it's called survival. When you're in a political arena, baby, yeah, it's called political survival. How's Wilbur Mills doing, by the way? How's the Newtmeister? You can't imagine why he's going to be skulking away, huh? With all those stories about him and his blowjobs and all the other bullcrap and all his mistresses and his dead wife, and he goes into the hospital while his wife is dying of cancer, and he goes into the hospital to get her to sign the divorce papers. Because he's busy doing his hanky-panky on the outside without Tommy James and the Shondells. Who are these people kidding? Get on the witness stand, and we're going to say, yeah, man, she had the best pair of lips. Can't you just see the President of the United States getting on there and giving us a blow-by-blow, so to speak? Can you see that?
No.
And neither can they. And they get in there and asking all these goddamn personal questions about the cigar and what brand was it, and did she stick it in her...
rectum.
In her, you know... Give me a frickin' break. Oh, well, he lied about that. Well, guess what? Who the hell wouldn't? And what does that have to do with running the country? What does that have to do with our government, whether she had a Tipperillo or a goddamn Swisher Sweet or something from Nick Cigars, we hope, of course, if they had good taste. Here's a mobile in Pompano. Hello.
Yeah, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, my man?
Great.
I'm a Major Neely.
Yeah.
I was at Pizza Loft in the parking lot the other day. I got four of your tapes.
Thank you.
And you're doing an amazing thing for charity.
Yeah.
And anybody that doesn't support that charity...
can blow it out their ass.
Yeah, no, it's worse than that. They should blow it out there. You know what?
Mm-hmm.
Rectum.
Rectum,
yeah.
There you go. Anyway, what's the total up to right now?
Total up to right now is $101,495 as I speak this moment.
What about having every one of those people that are on TV right now donate $1,000? I'm all for that.
Okay, well, Tarek Aziz is on there right now. He said he's coughing some up. There you go. There's Tarek Aziz, that crazy Iraqi bastard who never told a lie that he believed. Look at that, sitting in front of that stupid flag there with a bunch of 10th world lunatics over there. I say keep bombing them until they just can't stand it, until they say uncle, until they go out in the streets and start running around, until they start digging into bunkers and find that goddamn Saddam and take care of him himself, just like they did with Mussolini in Italy, and hang him from the goddamn last light pole if we leave one up. That's what we ought to do. Tarek Aziz, Iraqi deputy prime minister.
Nations?
Yeah, nations. Blow it out your ass, okay? crazy lunatics. We got to waste all these millions and billions of dollars because we have to keep bombing them into submission for a few months till they start building their crap all over again. I say this time, let's bomb them and make sure that they never have a chance to start building crap again. Let's nuke them. That's what I say. Let's fry them. By the way, do you know they put mayonnaise on? Okay, thank you. And we say to that. Very well said. I vote for this guy for president, okay? After they knock Bubba's ass out of there, which they're working on feverishly, let's put that guy in there. He said, let's blow their away, is what he said. He said, it's going to take more than one shot, is what he said. Open line of Dave. Look at how we got calls on there now. These people think they're getting hockey tickets. Well, I do have this pair. I actually have them. George is a witness. I got them. What happened to the other? Oh, there it is. Got Gordon Murphy's picture. Howdy doody on the ticket, this one. Panthers and the Oilers. Front row seats. Row 1, seats 9 and 10, section 133. Where's 133, by the way? Trying to think where that would be. I'm in 101. Maybe it's like right across from me. 133. Or maybe it's like way down in the corner. I have no idea where that is.
Hmm?
Well, you wouldn't know. Have you ever been in there? You haven't been in the new arena yet, the not National yet. Car Rectal Center. You'll be in there. You'll go sometimes.
To a concert, yeah.
You'll also go to a hockey game sometime.
I might.
You've been before, and I'm sure that if somebody came up with
free tickets
for you.
Yes.
It's 11:26 at 560 WQAM.
Not in Mike Blow.
No, Sodom's hiding a lot more than guns. They say they're weapons of mass destruction. I say we send them a couple megatons of bombing rockets. In the Gulf War, let him off the hook. I think it's time to give his butt a whoop. So it's time to load those B-1s up on Iraq. On Iraq. Till there's nothing left to see. On Iraq. Till Saturn 6 feet deep.
For the right zone is for immediate voting.
Blow up the cream. Bomb Iraq.
All right.
And they say he's got the guns and chemicals to burn, and then he might load him up on scud. If we let him prepare, we're gonna be wet. Because bomb Iraq. Bring it to an end. Bomb Iraq. Blow him up again. Bomb Iraq. Live on CNN. Bomb Iraq.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Bomb Iraq. Toast this stupid bomb, bomb Iraq. From here to kingdom come, bomb Iraq.
Oh my God, look at that. Well, I didn't leave enough. I'm having my Tyson beef strips. Oh God, those are good. I'm going to stop talking about them. Because luckily, my Publix at the Sawgrass, thank you very much, is stocking up on these like crazy, so there's never any shortage when I go in there. Or maybe you people are just too stupid to start eating this stuff, because God, is it good. Mmm, man. This is the same beef they use in all their, what you call it stuff. You know, the meat where they put in with the vegetables and all that stuff, the stir-fry stuff.
Oh.
Mmm, God, you melt a little cheese on there. And the best thing is you slice some onions in there, too. And you got a little meat in there, and you got an Atkins Delight, and it fills you up, and it's delicious. It's actually got some goddamn taste to it, as opposed to all that other shoe leather that you eat on the Atkins. So anyway, Steve from Pastry Lane Bakery Shop that brings us our Homintosh every year at Purim time call. He's a great guy. Saw him at the hockey game a couple of weeks ago. How you doing, Steve? He called off here to try to scan these hockey tickets in the parking pass. Hey, Steve, the answer is
no.
But nice try. Hey, he's a good guy, but I can't do that. I finally woke up. Oh, by the way, there's Baghdad. 7:34 p.m. It's nighttime there now. There's that goddamn laundry head, Tarek Aziz, sitting there lying through his teeth. We never sell a freight train. Yeah, right. In the meantime, there's traffic. They're driving around because they're waiting for that big moment, which it'll be, any time now. We'll have, what's her name back again? What is her name?
Who?
Christiana Amanpour.
Oh, my favorite. They're at 400. Whew. And it's, they're all gone.
Well, what do you mean they're all gone? If they had 15 cars, I see. So, in other words, we had the initial rush down there in Cutler Ridge. Well, $400, that's in 20 minutes, for Christ's sake. That's pretty goddamn good. What the hell do you want? So that brings us to $101,775, and they're down there with a QAM van at Publix in Cutler Ridge. That's four blocks, three blocks south of the Cutler Ridge Mall, US 1 and 113th on the east side. Just look for the big QAM van and look for Chris with his little black book taking numbers, and that's where they have all the Best of Neil stuff down there in Cutler Ridge. We'll do well over 1,000 there today, I guarantee it, or else. And here's Cutler Ridge right now. Hello.
How you doing, Neil?
Okay, sir.
I'm waiting for my lunch hour to hit so I can rush down there now. I work down here, so.
Great.
I've been hoping that you would bring one of your vans down here.
Yeah,
so
it's
about
time we got down where the audience is instead of wasting our time in Kendall with all those Julios.
Well, we thought you forgot about us.
I didn't forget.
Well, I live down at Homestead, and my wife and I are going to our Christmas party up in Broward tonight, which is going to be lots of fun. And her birthday's on Sunday, so I want to know if I could suck around.
What do you mean by that?
Well,
you'll be up there tonight?
Tonight, and we're going to stay tonight up there in Broward and hang around tomorrow, go to the swap shop, and then...
Well, listen, wish her a happy birthday, okay?
I'll do that.
Where is it? But the answer is no. Okay, we have an open line in today. That was a good story. They're going to be staying around in Broward tonight, and they're just kind of hanging around, like not necessarily in a place, just like out by the National Colorectal Center. Nice try, sir. Boy, this is good stuff. Well, let me ask you something. I don't understand. How come we have the strike against Iraq on right now, and it's goddamn Tarek Aziz, which we know he's full of crap, just like all those members of the House. How come if the speechman thing is so important that CNN has broken away? This is the problem. We got two damn things going on at the same time here, which I think is goddamn un-American, if you ask me. How can we be doing this now, and they're showing us there's nothing going on there in Iraq except a bunch of laundry heads driving around in old cars? By the way, did you know that Cesar Romero was, did you know that? So all you Julios out there that keep trying to be like Cesar Romero, Maricón, yeah, it's in that book I was reading. Cesar Romero, I didn't know that. Maybe that's why he dressed it with all those silly, flashy outfits. Here's a Lady Mobile in Boca. Hello.
Hi, Neil. How are you?
I'm great.
I just wanted to wish you a happy holiday, and I don't want the Panther tickets.
Good.
But like I've told you before, I seldom get a chance to listen to your show. So I was on my way home for a half day today and bought it. And it sounds like you're getting people going out there. And congratulations on your project right now. So in case I don't see or talk to you again, have a great holiday.
And have a great life. And thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Well, wasn't she nice, huh? There was somebody nice.
Uh-huh.
She don't want nothing. She's not just calling because we all of a sudden decided to give those tickets away right there up against the glass in the first row. You know how they make a big project every game? They take a couple who've been like sitting up in probably some pretty good seats with a good vantage point and can really see the game. And then they honor them by they put those balloons on, the Panther Patrol, and they stick their finger in there.
Rectum.
And they escort them down right to the front row where you can't see a goddamn thing. I mean, it's quite an honor to have these tickets right in the front row, but trust me, you won't see the game. Because you have no perspective. I mean, you'll be craning your head and looking anything along the boards. You just won't see anything. Now, maybe if you're down that low, you can see when the red light comes on down at that shoe twice end. Because since the first game or two, I haven't seen that red light once. You don't have to worry about it being too much like Amsterdam at the National Colorectal Center because we don't have no red light district. Not at that end. Are they ever going to do anything about that?
No.
I mean, I already gave up. I already said I don't care anymore. But how can you go to a hockey game and not care whether the red light comes on if there's a goal scored? Because every goal that's scored so far, I see it's in the net. I see it, like, right away, believe me. But there are going to be some, sooner or later, where it's like, you can't tell. And it would be nice to know before you get up and start screaming and carrying on whether it's the goal judge says it's a goal or not. Well, hey, don't confuse us with these things, okay? You're just making trouble again. You know, you people over there that are running that arena are a bunch of assholes. We build you a $200 million state-of-the-art arena. You can't get the goddamn escalator working out in front. You can't get the right damn piece on there. You got Randy Moeller promoting, giving highlights for a game that took place a week ago. You can't get the penalty clocks or the goddamn time clock working every game through one complete game. And you can't get the damn red lights and a green light in a position where the fans can see when a goddamn goal is scored or the period is over. And then they got the horn going off every now and then while the goddamn game is going on. But other than that, nice job. It's only the middle of December. I mean, if I'm involved in that organization, of course, they got plenty of their own problems, like not making the playoffs probably, but beside that, if I'm involved, at the very least, I mean, we've been showing up. They've had damn good attendance. They've had averaging over 18,000 a game. Damn good attendance. So the least you can do for those of us who bother to show up is, like, take care of those other details to give us a little bit of ambiance to pretend we're at a real game, which the other night we were actually for a change. So there you go. How do you like that?
Oh!
20 before noon at 560 WQA.
Hey, Neil, fuck you. There was a blue Elvis, and his tune said it's so blue. There in the bathroom, decorations of black on his casket, I see. That he won't cut any more LPs. I'll visit you, Elvis, in Graceland. There is next to Status and Burden.
All right.
You weren't feeling quite right. Then your face turned all white. Oh, then you turned blue, Elvis. Goodbye to you, Elvis. Forever. I'll bet you're still the king up there in heaven.
Neil, God!
Every night I'm at home and I'm watching TV. I have to sit through all his dumb movies and listen to Elvis whenever to cruise. It's now or never. But as I watch his flicks and I look at all those chicks, I wish I knew if they blew, Elvis. Oh, which ones blew, Elvis?
By the way, 79% of the people in the poll last night approve of the bombing and putting them into the Stone Age in Iraq.
Oh!
All right. And Tarek Aziz just said, hey, by the way, you ain't got it anymore, okay? Just give us your best shot. No, seriously, he pulled a Bernard Goetz. He said, okay, here's another one for us. Oh, sorry, I mean for you. No, for us? Okay, here's another one. Maniac, lunatic, he's like challenging, he's like threatening us, okay? If you people don't cut the crap, we're going to force you to nuke us. And we're going,
okay,
sure, okay. Two open lines in Dade County, 5 6, they're nuts. They're certifiable, okay? They're crazier than a bed bug. And they're these assholes and they're these righteous pontificators. And by the way, do you notice how Trent Lott was changing his tune yesterday? Oh, he really didn't mean this and he didn't mean that. And the comma was over here and the period was over there and Uranus was on his
rectum
and stuff like that. Yeah, right. Saw those polls the other night that like 99 and 9/10% of the people said, yeah, bomb them into the goddamn dark ages. and we like it. And all of a sudden, well, I was misinterpreted, I was misquoted, but and maybe they're not like alcoholics after all. And lunatics, rabid right-wing lunatics. And this is probably in the long run a good thing. It's a real good lesson for all you people out there that are like kind of a politically naive and don't get the message and don't understand what this is all about. Two open lines in Dade County, 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T Walrus line. And we will give away these tickets by 12:30, by the way, because you'll have to come and pick them up. And not too in the far distant future either, because it is Friday, naturally, and I'm sure our office staff, being close to the holidays, they'll be packing up real early today. That's the deal here at this building. They show up late, they leave real early, yes?
4:40 and really slow.
Well, I don't understand if there was this tremendous rush there in just a matter of moments in Cutler Ridge. Huh? Maybe they just all happen to be in the hood. Maybe the rest of them are driving in from like a few blocks away. $440 more for Center One, as we get very close to $102,000, by the way, today. Don't forget, we'll see at Borders in Plantation tomorrow, noon to 2, that's on Sunrise Boulevard. I don't understand why so many people don't know where that is or that it's so hard to get there. You just keep coming west on Sunrise until you can start smelling the alligators, and you'll know you're real close, almost to the National Colorectal Center. It's as you're coming west, it's on the right-hand side there. You'll see a Best Buy, and then you'll see an Amoco, and right in that block is the Borders. A big self-stand right there, almost on a goddamn street on Sunrise Boulevard.
I don't think you've mentioned enough that it's going to be the last appearance.
That's right. This is our last appearance tomorrow for this year for the Center One campaign, noon to 2 tomorrow. And I'm making a tremendous sacrifice. It's at least a 30-second drive from my house to get there. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Great.
I love all this... You know, Republicans spawned criticism against the timing and Clinton, and were they the ones that like to put these, fanatical lunatics in
power?
Yeah,
see, that's part of the problem. These are the same ones that have been screaming for months that he wasn't doing anything, and remember Orrin Snatch, he was screaming about, we ought to really just keep banging away and bomb him into the dark ages until the moon don't
shine.
Well,
you know, they never met an extremist they never liked.
Right.
So
it's really scary, though, to see the way that all of them, each and every one, there may be like a couple of renegades left, but just about each and every one have been whipped into line, and they got these people just all goose-stepping and lined up and intimidated. Maybe they got all the naked pictures from Larry Flynt. Maybe they're the ones that are releasing this stuff.
That's probably what it is. You know, I can understand CNN's conflict of interest because, you know, they need to rack up another 70 ACE awards.
Mm-hmm.
You know, go over there. Listen.
Yeah, Christiana needs some more awards.
Bernard Shaw.
Oh, look out, Christiana. Oh, there's another bullet on the roof, sweetheart.
Close.
Uh-huh.
Let me tell you something. Interesting story. When I was in my last year of high school, we went to see Silence of the Lambs.
Yes.
Friends. Now, I've been busting my guts laughing.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
I like the second one there better. I like the inflection on it. Yeah.
Yeah, it's like the emotional, mm-hmm. problems of old Buffalo Bill. The only one,
problems.
We would be laughing and laughing at this, and my girlfriend at the time, of course, thought we were all sick. But whenever we would drive, honest to God story, whenever we would drive down the street, we'd see a white van.
A
white van.
Oh yeah.
Which would be also kind of hard to see, and where in the middle of Nevada where I live. But a white van. We'd be driving down the road, and in the movie, Buffalo Bill kidnaps the girl in a white van. So we would go by and go up to the window and go, it puts the lotion in the back.
Yeah.
The same way, dude.
Great.
So you have brought back this wonderful holiday feeling.
All right.
For me, so you're number one, baby.
Okay, and have a happy.
You too.
Bye-bye. Yeah, that's going to be the new holiday greeting, by the way. Instead of Merry Christmas or Happy Hanukkah, just walk up to somebody you know and say...
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Two open lines in Dade County, 5670560. In fact, a tisket a tasket puts some lotion in your holiday basket. What's wrong with that? Oh, boy, I'm smoking a cheap cigar. Nick's not going to be too happy about that, I'll tell you. Well, you got to every now and then smoke a cheap one, so you appreciate the real good ones.
Especially since we're running low on the other ones.
Especially since we're running low on those real good ones from Nick's. I don't want to get John Penis all worked up into a frenzy again. Because he steals most of the good ones anyways, what I hear. Here's a mobile in Delray Beach. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I think what you're doing with Center One is fantastic.
Uh-huh.
And I just want to wish you Happy Hanukkah. I'm a longtime listener. Big hockey fan. And I went about 2 weeks ago for the first time to the new arena. And I think it's pretty nice. Although coming in, it reminds me of being in an airport somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you get the same impression, but... I would be interested in going down there tomorrow night with my lover who's never been to a hockey game.
Okay, really? Well, I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, we have an open line in, what? He said he'd be interested in going. I'm not sure there'll be tickets available. It's the Edmonton Oilers. That thing ain't going to be sold out. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's Hollywood. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Neil. How you doing?
Great.
I just wanted to express my disgust of the sports here in South Florida. How, being a longtime sports fan here, I lived here all my life, I think Wayne Huizenga is the worst thing that could ever happen to anybody in their state.
He's an asshole. Yeah.
And
I don't care if he gives $50 million to charity. He's still an asshole.
I think most of the people really hate him here.
Mm-hmm, and they do.
The sooner he gets back on his landfill on Sample Road, where he can stink like his landfill does, the better off he's going to be.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. I thought he already did stink like his landfill does. Yeah, it's really sad. You know, and of course, every time, I'm not saying he's not giving a lot of money to charity, because it is the end of the year. He needs a good tax write-off. But the fact is that every time he does that, there's this big article, and, oh, we're going to build another monument, another statue, and another wing named after him, et cetera, and so on. And anybody else that tries to do something, you know, scrape along whatever they're doing in this town, forget it. And like I said, if I were doing it for the publicity, I would have stopped doing it years ago, because there isn't any. Here's Mobile in Boca. Hello. Mobile in Boca.
Yes, hello.
Yes, sir.
Neil, how are you?
Great.
It's just great to finally get in touch with you. I've seen you the track a couple of times, but I never really wanted to come over to bother you up in the dining room. Number one, just expressing years of entertainment. I drive around, and my only moments of sanity are listening to your moments of insanity.
Me too.
And believe me, it's true. And as far as the fundraising efforts, that's not sucking around. It's just a tremendous thing that you do, and I don't think $20 for a cassette of your greatest hits is any type of a donation to begin with. I think it's something that they should be doing to begin with. Two questions I have for you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Concerning the International Liars Club, is there any difference between Wayne Hussein and Saddam Hussein-ga?
Okay, we'll think about it. Okay, we have an open line in Broward, 5670560 and pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. I don't know what he's talking about, and that makes several of us. Oh, here, now look at this one. This
but
is James Logan from California,
conduct.
Who's got the
this
hair.
Congress.
I mean, he doesn't have the mustache yet, but he doesn't need it. Look at the way he's got the hair down, like over to one side of his head, just like Adolf. Every time I see this guy, I get goosebumps. In fact, this guy and Bob Barr, I think they are going to elope, like over the weekend, like dark in the middle of the night, about 2:30 in the morning. I think they're going to hop in their white van and elope.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Oh, this guy. Every time I see him, I get the chills. I get the willies. 4 minutes before 12 at 560 WQM. I'll tell you something that'll give you the chills, and that's a big, big pint. Well, it's really not that big. You know, how about a half a gallon? Well, they don't make half gallons because they'd like you to live beyond the weekend. Can you imagine if Ben and Jerry's made half gallons or gallons? Decrease the surplus population, I'll tell you that. Put a lot of people away with a big smile on their puss. There's nothing in the world like Ben and Jerry's. You people out there that like these other off-brand or even these pseudo ice creams, man, you got taste in your tush. Ben and Jerry's, easily anybody would taste. Even over there in Amsterdam, they don't put their mayonnaise on the ice cream. They save that for their fries. They do put their lotion in the basket. But I'm telling you, Ben and Jerry's is so good that it's addictive. It's on the list of the most addictive substances in the history of the USA. And, of course, Ben & Jerry's fish food, the best flavor in the world. It's chocolate ice cream with gooey caramel marshmallow and loaded with little chocolate pieces shaped like fish. So good that you'll be spazzing out when you try it for the first time. They also make fish sticks, which is fish food on a stick covered in thick, hard chocolate to tide you over in between pints until you get home near the microwave. And Ben & Jerry's, all their flavors are spectacular. Cherry Garcia, chocolate Cherry Garcia, New York Super Fudge Chunk, Chubby Hubby, Chunky Monkey, Chocolate Chip Cookie Dough, Heath Bar Crunch, Dastardly Mash, and many of the flavors come in the frozen yogurt, which is so good it tastes just like real ice cream. It is out of this world. So pick up a whole bottle, you know, for the holidays, pick up 40 or 50 pints at your favorite supermarket, convenience store, your mobile station, or visit the two Ben & Jerry's scoop shops. There's one in Miami at the Aventura Mall, right between Bloomingdale's and the AMC Theaters, and one on Miami Beach, 760 Ocean Drive. For the holidays, just pig out on Ben & Jerry's.
This is 560 QAM.
Were you fudge packing him?
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
Oh!
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
Boy!
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
Third day of bombings underway.
Iraq's a crappy little country. Smells like the mustache on his face. Just get rid of that.
and drink a chubby and blow up the whole goddamn place.
Oh!
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
What high?
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
Oh, God.
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
Call 02 at 560 WQM. We've got tremendous news for you, boys and girls. Two pieces of tremendous news. Number one, the third day of bombing is underway.
Oh.
Tariq Aziz said, okay, give us your best shot. And we said, okay, here's some more for you. It's going to go on for hours today. Because it's only like 8 o'clock at night over there right now, 8.02 in the p.m. Even I can figure that out, even if Dan Rather can't for all that money. And so that means we got hours and hours and hours that the bombs will be bursting in air. That's number one piece of good news. Number two piece, wait until you hear this. Strap yourselves in. I'm a little skeptical about these studies, okay? But nevertheless, you always believe the studies that are the most, you know, when they tell you what you want to hear. Wait till you hear this one. Study says chocolate lovers may live longer.
Oh. All right.
Scientists already have suggested that eating chocolate may make you happy. Now they say men who indulge in chocolates may live longer.
Oh!
A study of 7,841 Harvard male graduates found that, now that, this is not, we're not talking about fudge, okay? That's a different category. They live a lot shorter. 7,841 Harvard male graduates found that chocolate and candy eaters, regardless of how voracious their appetite for the goodies, live almost a year longer than those who abstain.
Oh!
The researchers from Harvard University School of Pubic Health, whose study was published in this week's issue of the British Medical Journal, said they don't know why this is. They speculate, however, that antioxidants present in chocolate may have a health benefit. Oh, give me those antioxidants. Let me shovel them down my puss. The scientists stressed, in fact, what's the main ingredient in fish food? Rich, thick chocolate. With that marshmallow and that gooey caramel, like the just streams, ribbons of caramel inside. Oh, there's a Saddam. Yeah.
Supporting with them in their battle against right. This light should be everywhere.
Get him out of my face. Hey, Saddam, there's another one for you, okay? You laundry head, you asshole, you barbarian, you lunatic with a bad mustache and a real bad complexion. Anyway, in the study, those who ate a moderate amount of sweets, allowing themselves only 1 to 3 candy bars a month, fared the best. Well, now that's not so good. Having a 36% lower risk of death compared with non-candy eaters. What was that again? 1 to 3 candy bars a month. I can do that in an hour. Although they fared worse than the moderates, those who ate 3 or more sweets a week still live longer than those who ate no candy, with a 16% decreased risk of death. How do you like that? So in other words, if you want to live 36% longer, eat like 1 to 3 candy bars a month. If you want to like live 16% longer, when in doubt, pig out. Just shovel it down. And the candy, too. And the whatever kind of chocolate you want. We got any chocolates? You got any more of those Hershey's with chocolates in there? No, seriously, I would like to live 16% longer than the next couple of years. Oh, look at that. All right.
All right.
Oh, look at that. Boy, you must have hid those well, because that was all over that refrigerator. Hershey's cookies and cream, these little Hershey's are not kisses, but they're like, oh, this is white chocolate. Ooh, fat.
With brown chocolate in them. I bought an assortment.
What does that mean? What else was in there?
Oh, this is the last of it.
Huh?
This is the last of it.
This sucks. You like white chocolate? I mean, I'll eat it.
I got it for mostly other people.
Oh. I got
I like the with almond.
I like sweet, okay? I do like stuff that's sweet. For example, I like Pepsi better than Coke only because it's sweeter. But this is sickeningly sweet because it's white chocolate. Oh, but I'll eat it because I want to live longer. What are you laughing about? Huh? The more you eat, the longer you live. In fact, I think 20 or 30 pints of fish food on the way home sounds good to me because most of it is chocolate. Let's hear it for chocolate, baby.
Oh!
Here's a mobile in Boca. Hello.
Yeah, Neil, I just wanted to give a spy report on the borders in Boca Raton.
Yes, sir.
Looks like they only have maybe... First of all, bring your cash because they don't accept checks. And there's a Sun Bank I had to go to the ATM because I bought actually quite a few for everybody just stocking this. So bring your cash.
Okay.
They only have maybe 10 cassettes left of each and maybe 3 or 4 CDs. And
yeah, we had a gigantic week there.
Yeah, it looks like so if you want it, you better get there ASAP. And the lady who helped me had no idea what I was talking about.
Yeah.
And the guy had to step in.
That may be good.
And I just wanted to see if I could suck around for tickets. I'll turn around right now and come and get them if I could.
Okay.
Excellent. That'd be wonderful.
Are you shocked?
I am. I'm really shocked.
Well,
I'm really excited.
I just had a piece of this candy. If I wouldn't have eaten the candy, I would say blow it out your ass. But since I didn't... No, seriously, I'm in a very good mood. You know how candy affects the endorphins in your brain? It sends all those... kind of calms down to your pleasure center of your brain?
I'm exiting the turnpike right now.
Okay. Hang on.
All right.
Okay, give that guy directions and parking pass, the yellow preferred parking pass, which, boy, is right by the escalator that doesn't work. Have they got that escalator fixed yet, by the way?
No.
Don't these people have any shame that operate that National Colorectal Center? Do they have any shame at all?
No.
Man, oh, man, put on a show, for Christ's sakes, for the tickets that you're gouging the public, for the prices of those tickets. Oh, and then Geldy says, well, you know, they got the Panther pack. Yeah, 500 seats, okay, for each game out of a 19,000-some-odd-seat arena. 500 seats if you're lucky enough to be able to get one of those. And, of course, the rest of the poor bastards, do they have any chance of getting them?
No.
Of course not. The tickets are like an arm and you have to, like, mortgage the house to go to a game with your family. And then, of course, the overpriced food. I mean, give us a break, will you, please? Wayne, you bald-headed bastard. Well, you know, if he's going to give all that money to charity, we've got to give it to him. Yes?
They're up to 500.
Yeah.
And a lady left a sweater there, a nice blue sweater. So she's listening.
Oh, some lady left your blue sweater there at the QAM van, so go back and get it. She probably left her name and address and a little calling card inside. Maybe she does some extra work on the weekend. She wanted to leave Chris a little message. That's the old trick, you know, leave like an article or clothing, leave something behind. And always a good excuse to come back. Oh, did I leave this here? Oh, and by the way, Chris, you know what I'm saying? Throw up to $500 down there at the QAM van down by the Publix, three blocks south of Cutler Ridge Mall. On the east side of US 1 and Southwest 113th Street. Just look for the QAM van. Chris will be inside, and he's got the best in the CDs and the cassettes, the T-shirts. And we got probably, do we still have more Free Dolphin T-shirts for everybody comes by? I'm sure we do.
I'm pretty sure
we do. So let's do over 1,000 there today. I mean, we had $400 like that, like greased lightning, like Jewish lightning in a bottle. But now all of a sudden it slowed down to a crawl. Just when we thought Cutler Ridge was going to go bananas today, and then they slowed right down. 9 minutes past noon at 560 WQAM.
WQAM, go f*** yourself.
While spending the remainder of your golden years in the land of death, the one thing you have to depend on is your car. With Jew Canoe theft on the rise, the people who brought you a big black guy named Ben Car Alarm now bring you an old Jewish guy named Isaac.
Get away from my automobile, you big MF.
Remember when we used to boost them back in Caribbean?
Yeah, yeah.
And we ought to get a bundle finish, baby. Yeah. The white ones are cooler.
Yeah.
Get away from my automobile, you big MF.
What the hell is that?
I object seriously to profanity like that.
Slow down, I think somebody's got it.
Get away from my automobile, you big MF. Get away from my automobile, you big MF.
Whenever some bastard tries to steal my car, I feel safer with an old Jewish guy named Eisen.
Get away from my automobile, you big MF.
Get your old Jewish guy named Eisen car alarm now and receive a free flower antenna.
Get away from my automobile, you big, big MF.
An old Jewish guy named Eisen car alarm. Now available at all their stores.
1214, 1215, 1216, whichever one you like here at 560 WQM. This from the Palm Beach Post. Russian leaders appeal to Lewinsky to halt Iraq attack.
Oh!
This is serious. This is for real from the AP. Russian legislators agreed Thursday to consider a motion appealing to Monica Lewinsky to help halt the American attack on Iraq. The state Duma appeals to Ms. Lewinsky to undertake corresponding measures to restrain the emotions of Bill Clinton, said the motion by nationalist lawmaker Alexander Filatov. The motion was approved on a vote in the Duma, the lower chamber of parliament, to be considered for inclusion in a broader resolution denouncing the Iraq attack. The communists also mentioned Clinton and his relationship with a former White House intern. Many people link it with Clinton's impeachment and his intimate relations with a certain person, but if these relations develop into such acts of vandalism, then all U.S. democracy is worth a penny, communist leader Gennady Zyuganov told a Duma debate on the Iraqi crisis. Okay? Come on, Monica. Just one more good blowjob, sweetheart. That should calm him down. Only this time, you know, a little better dress. Something nice, like an evening gown would be nicer. A little more attractive. A little more classy. Two open lines in Dade, 5670560 and #560 on the mobile one line. Here's Coconut Grove. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
We got a Julio sophomore at the University of Miami here.
All right.
You want to talk about a dead place? Oh, Lordy.
Yeah.
That school's horrible.
What is it? What school is it?
University of Miami, Neil.
Oh, U of M. Oh,
oh
yeah.
You got a bunch of, oh, just deadbeats and the thugs, the football teams walking around. How you be doing?
The hurricane fucking blow.
Yeah, well, that's I what I hear.
That far.
Mm-hmm.
Aside from that, some hockey talk, if I may.
Yes.
How do you feel about Mr. Dvorak? Are we going to expect anything?
How do I feel about him? I don't. He's a non-factor.
Non-factor.
He does nothing. He skates better, he's faster, and he does nothing. He doesn't finish, he's useless.
He can't put the biscuit in the basket.
He can't put the biscuit in the can. That's right, the lotion in the basket. That's right.
Exactly.
We got a few stiffs on there that I'm sure they'd like to get rid of. He's one of them. Kirk Muller is another one. And who's the third one? And, of course, Garpenlov, totally useless. I don't think he's even got a point this year. And they got these guys under contract, and they just have to keep paying the money out and pretending these guys are going to do something, and they don't.
Well, why is it then that when they go to other teams that they just absolutely excel?
Well, who's that? You mean like Ray Sheppard? Ray Sheppard was a proven 50-goal scorer. He had one bad year, and they dumped him. And, of course, now he's having a big year for Carolina. And as far as Stu Barnes and Marty Straka, we already knew they were both good players, and the same with Jason Woolley. But for whatever reason, we like Criswell's haircut.
Right. Can I shuck around for some tickets?
If we had some, I'd be happy to give them to you.
Oh, well.
And have a great day.
All right,
you too. We had one pair, folks, okay? I mean, I realize we don't want to put you out. We don't want to have too many calls here on the board, because if we do, then we should be suspicious and know they're sucking around. No more tickets, okay? Enough of the shucking. Too much sucking.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Or somewhere. Datelines are open, 5670560, #560 on the mobile one line. So the attack, the Iraq attack, continues for the third day. William Cohen was just on there going, ba 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 like that. William Cohen, how the hell could they suspect him, a former Republican senator from Maine, a Republican who happens to be the Secretary of Defense, like this guy's going to put his integrity and his ass on the line, and all of a sudden Trent Lott said, well, what I really meant was, yeah, right, we believe you, you Nazi bastard, you no-good piece of walking excrement on legs. 580. See, there you go. We goosed it up down there in Cutler Ridge. Let's go. Let's get that $1,000 down there in Cutler Ridge today and stop playing hard to get. I thought we finally hit the mother load down there today where we had that big start and we had 15 cars lined up and it sounded like, hey, we finally hit the right joint. And then, as usual, it slows down to a crawl. Publix, do you understand where it is? 3 blocks south of Cutler Ridge Mall, the QAM van. That's where it's at with all our Best of Neil stuff. $580. We need 420 more for a nice 1,000 today. Let's see. 580 puts us at 101, almost at 102,000, just underneath. We're getting close. One open line at Broward all of day. Isn't this interesting? I wish we had a photographer in here to take a picture of the phone bank as soon as I announced we got that one lousy pair of hockey tickets in the parking pass. Because we're fighting. We got the breaking news from Iraq. We got the goddamn speech hearings going on here in the House. We're fighting against a bunch of brainwashed people. They're not paying any attention to what I'm doing here today. We got 40 people out there listening to this show today. But boy, as soon as you got something to give away, wow, they all light up like a goddamn Hanukkah bush in heat, man. All of a sudden, they're in love with me. They're obsessed. They drop everything, including their drawers. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, have you seen any new movies at the Gaiety?
Yeah, yeah. How about you?
Yeah.
They ain't there no more, okay, pal? So when you're standing in line, I hate to break the news to you, asshole, dumb Julio. Open line at Broward 2 and Dade, 5670560, #560 on the, mobile one line. Have I seen any new movies at the Gaiety? Yeah, go take a look on our marquee. Is it still there, pal? Take a good close look. When you're on the way down from the goddamn liquid. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Okay.
Love your show.
Uh-huh.
I really just wanted to hear that whole bit, the Buffalo Bill bit.
Yeah.
But I told George that I wasn't calling to suck around or anything like that. I just wanted to hear that bit.
Okay, well, keep listening.
And George insisted I talk to you, so.
Uh-huh.
He said, what the heck?
Well, because we hardly have any calls, we got some dumb Julio on there that's got a bug up his ass because his boyfriend left him. I'll work on it, pal. Maybe one more time before the day is out, we'll play.
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Open line in Broward, 2 and Dade, 5670560, #560 on a mobile one line. Here's a letter to the editor. One good thing, if there is to come out during the recent charade known as the House Judiciary Committee hearing on impeachment, is that the new face of the Republican Party is yada, yada, yada. Representative Bob Barr from Georgia and Tom DeLay of Texas have emerged as the new leaders. Both men were calling for the impeachment long before Monica Lewinsky and Linda Tripp's names became household words. That's right. They already wanted him out of there, even if he wasn't getting blowjobs. How do you like that? Excellent letter. Who wrote that letter? Charles Way in Lake Worth. Way, baby. That's what he said. Eat your Kurds and... Okay, in fact, isn't that what we're doing? We're bombing the Kurds in Way? Here's a mobile in Cutler Ridge. Hello.
Good afternoon.
They said, we're going to go over there and bomb the Kurds. They said, no way. And we said, Way? Wait. Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Okay.
I just wanted to report that I'm looking at this CD. I just bought two CDs from you.
Thank you.
And, yeah, well, thank you. There's a lot of crap on here.
There's a lot of great stuff. I keep telling everybody that, and then they just sit there twiddling their thumbs.
Well, on the first one, there's 42 cuts. I can't believe it.
Right. And each and every one of them is an award winner, including Ganja Be Good and Playing Bagpipes. The greatest stuff I've ever played on the air in my life is on here, and we've had a push and prod, but they're getting there now. We're starting to kick some ass.
This thing's worth $20 just for Ganja Be Good, man.
Right, I agree. I agree with it wholeheartedly. That's right.
Well, you have a great day, Neil.
Where can you buy that much for $20?
That's right.
And have a great delay.
Thank you. Bye.
Two open lines in Dade, 5670560, pound 560 on the Mobile One line. Yeah, we continue fighting these recalcitrant Julios out there who have to put on this big act for their boyfriends like they, you know, like I'm maricón. In the meantime, what the hell are they? A bunch of pajaritos is what they are. That's right. Little pajaritos. Is that redundant? Here's a lady mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
¿Cómo se dice redundant en español? Yes, ma'am.
Hi, I'm a Julia Porter. And I just love you.
Great, there you go.
I hear you, and I also
here's
watch
a lady
you
who's out of the closet. What is it?
Huh? I watch you also every night.
Well, you're the one that's watching that thing. Well, watch fast.
Yeah. But anyway, I just want you to know that us Julias and Porkers, we're not all that bad.
Okay. Have a happy, sweetheart.
You too.
Feliz Navidad.
Same to you.
Hasta que me olvides.
Happy Hanukkah.
Arrivederci.
Bye.
Ciao. Open line at Broward, 5670560. Boy, I'm going to tell you something. I feel like I'm going to live at least another 2-3 minutes after reading that. And by the way, don't buy any more white chocolate, please. And don't tell me you bought a sample pack.
I did. I bought a whole bunch.
Yeah. So where's the good stuff?
We ate it already.
What do you bring the dreck in here for? What do you mean we ate it? I had like 4 pieces from that.
I didn't say we as
and you know something? That isn't that good anyway. Hershey's chocolate is very pedestrian. What?
Oh, that's blasphemy.
No, it is not. Nestle's makes better stuff than they do. Who do you think makes Smarties? Nestle's makes Smarties, for example.
Yeah, but I like
them. Even though I'm OD'd on Smarties, I can't eat them anymore. But Nestle's makes
the Hershey's with almonds.
No.
Oh, that's
You know what? You know what Hershey's with almonds taste like? The candy bar you're talking about?
No, like the nuggets that I had that you were eating the other day.
Neil's nuggets? No. Seriously, Hershey's candy is waxy. Good candy is good. Chocolates are not waxy. In fact, you can hear old Greg Budell talk-ups on there. They got waxy buildup.
$6.60, by the way.
No, seriously, stop and think about it. When you eat a Hershey's chocolate bar, and I'm not saying I'm averse to eating them if they happen to be laying around, especially with almonds, but they're waxy.
I disagree.
It's not a question of whether you did. Oh, here we go again. The voice of reason has spoken. He disagrees. It's like saying Pepsi is sweeter than Coke. Oh, I disagree. Okay, disagree, but it happens. It's a fact. It's not something I just picked out of my ass like a seed. Jesus, man, you are brutal.
Every year, Hershey wins all those awards for the
best. I don't. Oh, okay, and so does what's his name? So does Lyle. I love it. Okay, he wins country music awards. Can he sing? Does he look like a human being? He wins awards. Big deal.
Yeah, in country music.
Sucks.
Right.
And so they have a lot of those awards, too. Does that mean that it's worth getting an award?
No.
Of course not. Hershey's wins awards. Hershey's is waxy. Give me some Perugina. Some of those Dutch chocolates. How about some of those great Belgian chocolates? Now we're talking. How about some Perugina Bocce? Sounds good. Here's a mobile in Homestead. Hello.
Hey, Neil, what's up?
Yes, sir.
Hey, listen, about that study, I guess we're going to have you for another 100 years, huh?
That's right, because I'm eating up a storm, man.
Hey, but listen, I don't know if you're interested or even care, but there's Furbies in that Target in Cutler Ridge.
Furbies in the Target store in Cutler Ridge. Oh! There's going to be riots now.
I just got two for my kids, you know, finally.
Thank you so much, pal. You got all everybody. Right, they're going to be shooting each other. You'll read about it over the weekend.
Oh, well.
Thanks for the good news.
Later.
Okay. Here's a guy just got two Furbies for his kids in the Target in Cutler Ridge.
Oh!
They're going to be marching on here. Now we won't raise another dime because they're all going to vamoose from where our guys are. $660 down there at Cutler Ridge so far today. Not bad, not too shabby. We'll make $1,000 by 2 o'clock if it's the last goddamn thing we do, or else Chris will never take that van down there again. I don't want to threaten the people at Cutler Ridge. But all we need is another $340. That's 17 more CDs, cassettes, T-shirts, combination of thereof, piece of cake. And that'll put us over 102 grand handily for the day. And don't forget, noon to 2 tomorrow at the Borders and Plantation on West Sunrise Boulevard. Easy to get there. Like I told you, just come west on Sunrise. Just keep coming and you'll see it. And the Borders, too. 1226 at 560 WQMW.
Hi, this is Maury Povich wishing you a happy Hanukkah.
Jingle balls, man, what a bitch. Jingle balls whirring and jingle balls itch. I've got a dozen on my behind. They all have names and I'm glad they're mine. Jingle balls come from a lack of hygiene. Way too much chili, too many beans. Cheap toilet paper at my mother-in-law's gave me jingle balls. You can hot wax, you can sneeze them, it really hurts just the same. But when I have gas, just a match to my ass, I'll send some screaming in a big blue flame. Grab a big patch and give them a yank. What have you got to lose? Try an M80 and kiss them goodbye. That's the dingle ball.
1:32 at 560 WQM, the Hank Goldberg Show, cut off at 2 to 6 this afternoon. We got the Booster at 6. We got Eddie Kaplan with the odds on impeachment and killing all the Iraqis at 10 o'clock tonight. So the Target store, the guy was just talking about, that's got the Furbies for all you people that are shopping for the holidays and are ready to kill your neighbor if you don't get one for your pain in the ass little kids. Target is right across from where we are with our QAM van today. How do you like that?
Oh!
We got $700 with an hour and a half to go. 700 big ones, baby. Oh, look at this. They're showing the bombings, and they're showing exactly what they're wiping out over there. What?
This is great.
Yeah, I love
it. How direct
you can watch,
it is.
Okay, watch real close, and you can see he's got it in the crosshairs as the strike. You can see that he was right in the center of his crosshairs, so
oh, look at
precision
that.
Guidance that he has both on board the aircraft
and there it goes.
Mechanism
wow.
He was able to do it. This is
beauty, good hit. So they're showing the diaphragms and diagrams, but you notice on the chart we still got a lot of work to do. Huh? Still missed several of those. In fact, there's still a few of those terrorists over there that are still alive. But we're working feverishly right now. We're bombing them into the Stone Age. Nice going.
Oh!
Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Yeah, can you play Prison Bitch?
No. Open line at Broward and 2 and Dade, 5670560 and pound 560 on the mobile one line. We played Prison Bitch yesterday, sir. If you snooze, you lose. That's all I can tell you. That's coming up again next year sometime. Here's Little Havana. Hello.
Hey, Uncle Neil.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, man?
Hey,
they're marching out of the closet, all these skeletons now, man. This guy admitted about fooling around.
Mm-hmm.
And
well, he admitted, yeah, because Larry Flint brought him out of the closet.
Well, at least
he
was smart. Because at least he admitted before he had to lie, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
And talking about that.
He admitted what? He said that he had several affairs. We don't know how many. We don't know who they were with. We haven't put him under a cross-examination yet. We're not holding any hearings. We're not forcing him to put his hand on the Bible or on his rectum. So who the hell knows what he's telling us,
right.
You know?
I want to know who's going to be the next with balls and admit that it's a fag.
Yeah.
I tell you what, then la mierda is going to hit a ventilador.
Exactly.
You know, Neil, shameless request,
yes.
Please. A couple of how to spell with Donnell.
Okay.
Thanks, guys.
Arrivederci. What's he saying? What language is that guy talking in? They're learning to spell with Darnell.
This is learning to spell with Darnell. I'll be Darnell Jackson, and today we're going to spell the word broken. Spell it with me now. Broken. B-R-O-K-E-N. Now, let's use it in a sentence. So I says to the coach, I says, man, that bro can show throw a football. This is Learning to Spell with Darnell. I'll be Darnell Jackson.
All right.
This is Learning to Spell with Darnell. I'll be Darnell Jackson. And today we're going to spell the word eyes. Spell it with me now. Eyes. E-Y-E-S. Now, let's use it in a sentence. I'm so glad I still got me a job. This is Learning to Spell with Darnell. Yes, and I'll be Darnell Jackson.
1235 at 560 WQM. I wouldn't be surprised if Bob Barr from Georgia was one of those guys up in the woods there in Aintree. Wouldn't surprise me at all. Think that mustache is covering it up?
No.
I don't think so. Two open lines in Dave. 5670560, #560 on the mobile one line. What's that grand total you asked, huh? Well, look at that. The 700 puts us over 102 grand now. $102,075, and we're still going strong down there at Cutler Ridge, and we will go over $1,000 today there, won't we?
Uh-huh.
Yes, we will. And we'll have a big day at Plantation Borders tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
Yes, we will. Here's a mobile in Plantation. Hello.
Yeah, hi. How you doing, Neil?
Okay.
Well, is Darnell Jackson asking about Dan Marino or something? That's a good bit, sir.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, I was calling about the crucifixion that's going on the over there in the house.
Yes.
Oh, my God, Neil.
The lynching, yes.
Oh, Jesus Christ, Neil. And
there's a crucifixion going on. He's usually close by.
I say God is everything, and evil is the Republicans.
Yeah.
That's what the definition of evil, you're going to see next to the dictionary, you're going to see the whole Republican bastards that are doing
in the dictionary, right. Okay, yeah. God bless you, sir, and get that passport. Clutch it real tight, pal. And we have an open line at Broward 1 and Dade, 5670560 and #560 on the mobile one line. So they're coming out of the closet. The Republicans have unmasked themselves. All the facade has been taken off, okay? They're showing their robes and their hoods. In fact, that one guy's name was La Hood. See that one of the first guys? He was, and he wasn't from the hood either, I guarantee you that. Too lily white to be from the hood. Showing exactly where they're coming from as they goose-step dutifully into line. And they, you know, don't confuse them with the facts. Don't confuse them with what the American people think is important these days or what else is going on in the world. Because they want to show that the Constitution works. Right. Anybody believe that?
No.
Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I'll send your sales through the roof. Can I make a suggestion?
Yeah.
Have you tried, and I listen regularly, but I haven't heard this, trying like 10, 15 seconds of each bit so people can know exactly which ones are on there? Because, for example, I was trying to find, if you played like 20 seconds of each bit and then told where it was sold, I bet you a lot of people would go get it. Because I was trying to find out, for example, the Bridge Tender.
Yeah.
Is the Bridge Tender on there?
No. It's on Neil's Nuggets, which you can get by calling Center One, or we'll have it at our borders tomorrow.
Neil's Nugget?
Right, it's one of the old ones. It's got all the old good stuff on it, like the Bridge Tender.
Okay.
You never want to hear again.
Okay, I didn't know that. And then one other question. Is that the old Neil's Nugget, the old Nugget thing?
Oh, Neil's Old Nuggets, yeah.
Right. Does that have that one bit, I know, I remember with
no.
Phil Hendry when he was at the drive-thru?
Phil Henry at the drive-thru?
You remember when he was doing that thing at the drive-thru and you couldn't understand what the hell he was saying? It was hysterical. He goes, rah, 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 rah.
And that was a Rick and Suds thing, not a Phil Henry thing.
That was a Phil Henry. Okay, well, so anyway, do you have any Phil Henry stuff on there, too?
No.
Okay, and then one last thing.
Yeah?
Phil Bryce is money.
Okay, what did he say? I have no idea what he's talking about. Do you have any idea what he's...
No.
We have an open line. We do have some Phil Henry blow-up dolls over there for you, sir. I think one could come in handy in your case. We have an open line at Broward. Phil's kind of embarrassed about it. 5670560 and #560 on the mobile one line. 21 till 1 at QAM.
This is the Neil Rogers Show. This is your brain. Any questions?
Now, a day in the life of three Baptists.
Hey, fellas, let's do something.
I feel like doing something.
Me too.
How's about we go shopping, like the Kmart?
That's a good idea.
Yeah, let's go Kmart shopping.
Wait a minute.
What?
We can't.
Why not?
Well, because Kmart's doing a promotion on that there Hercules movie put out by Disney.
All right, I think I got it.
What?
Well, let's go see The Lost World, that Jurassic Dinosaur movie.
Oh, that's
a great movie.
Wait a minute.
What?
We can't.
Why not?
Because Jeff Goldblum's in that, and he used to date Laura Dern.
Oh.
Go there.
Well, there's always a baseball game.
I like baseball.
I too.
Wait a minute. What? We can't.
Why not?
Because the only game on is the Yankee game.
Yeah, so?
Steinbrenner didn't do nothing.
Yeah, but they're playing the Angels.
Oh,
Disney! Can't do that.
Well, hey, let's watch some TV. NBC's got Third Rock from the Sun. NBC's all right. We can watch that.
We can watch it.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. We can't.
Why?
Because Third Rock stars John Lithgow, who was in that Footloose movie with Kevin Bacon, who was in that Meryl Streep movie, The River Wild, and Meryl was in Silkwood with Cher and Kurt Russell, and Kurt was in
The Computer Wore Tennis Shoes. Disney!
We can't.
But, hey, looky here in the paper. Luke Perry signing autographs down at the record store.
I like Luke Perry.
Yeah.
We're
going
to see Luke.
Wait
a minute. We can't.
Why not?
Because Luke was in The Fifth Element with Bruce Willis, who was in Die Hard 2 with John Amos from Good Times, who used to live next door to Calvin Klein.
Oh.
Yep. Oh, well. Looks like it's Deliverance again.
Well, that cornhole sure is special. 1245 at 560 WQM. Isn't that what Ned Beatty said, that corn? Okay, here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hello there.
Yes, sir.
I just want to congratulate you wholeheartedly on your efforts with Center One.
Well, thank you wholeheartedly.
Someone should raise a statue to you, not...
No, I don't want no statues. I don't want no credit, because I learned a long time ago that when you're a miserable bastard that tells it like it is, and you rip the newspapers in ass and expose them for being the phonies that they are, they're not going to give you credit for anything. So I'm content just to do a good job and get them all that cash, and that's it.
You know, I was on the road up by, Coconut Creek, and I was driving by Wayne's Monument, the one that he erected to himself on Temple and... The turnpike, you know, that 55 or what is it, 100-foot high garbage heap?
Yeah, the 2,000-foot high one, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. That's
which
that
has a striking, even the aroma is very similar.
Let me ask you, as far as the political process that we have going on, the charades, what do you suppose, do you think the Republicans are committing Harry Caray here? I think
no.
We're going to have a...
Yes.
Democratic president for the next 8 years, 9 years.
I'd say for the next 24 years sounds reasonable to me, and we're going to have Democratic overwhelming Congress in the year 2000.
It's going to be a
backlash. Like I said, the Republicans have discovered their own Y2K problem, baby, a big one.
Exactly. I'm happy for it. Anyways, like they say, when one door closes,
another one opens, and Zygazun. Like the Christophers used to say, light one little candle and stick it in your
rectum.
Okay, it's 13 to 1, the big 13 and the big 1 here on this amazing Friday. Boy, I tell you, we're getting real close to the end of this year. Close to our one-year anniversary here on WQAM.
Oh!
Wow, close to moving upstairs on the third floor. Anybody believe in that?
No.
I hear the Power 96 studios, by the way, are luxurious and beautiful. George was telling me this morning that they're amazing, astonishing, especially for a cheap-ass outfit like this place. So that's a real good start, but in the meantime, here's Miami. Hello.
Neil, how are you?
Okay, sir.
I got to tell you, I'm a Republican, but I do not know where they're headed. I'll tell you, I got to find a new group.
They're headed right over the edge of that infamous cliff that everybody's always talking about. They're headed all together. They've joined foot in lockstep, and they've joined arms, and they're all going over together.
And these guys are out of control.
Mm-hmm.
The second thing is, I was looking at various countries around Europe who either support or don't support this. You know, Italy doesn't support the strike.
Well, they're kind of like in between.
They said it's a useless useless endeavor. But
that's today. Wait till tomorrow.
I'll be careful when you go over there next time.
Yeah.
And if you could do one more thing for me.
Yes.
You could play the WQAM broadcast school.
So you don't have to worry about what the Italian government says, because in a week it'll be a different bunch of guys anyway.
I will.
Have a great day.
Be careful.
WQAM school of what? What is that under? George.
WQAM.
What's under WR?
WQAM is proud to bring you the WQAM School of Broadcasting.
Oh!
Yes, you too can have an illustrious career in the wonderful world of radio if you follow our curriculum. The course is free. Of course, you'll work for free. Call 1-800-WANNABE and speak to our Director of Education, Mr. Lenny Marquez.
No, you want to be a broadcaster.
A what?
A broadcaster, a broadcaster.
Yes.
No, broadcaster.
Broadcaster.
Well, can you say news?
News.
No, it's not news, it's news.
News.
I'll take you on a tour, you need help. Here we have the Joe Rose Beginner's Course.
Oui.
Repeat after me, man. We
over here we have the effective delivery world.
We know what you need. We need you. Give us a call. All you gotta do is call us right now. Repeat after me.
And over here we have the health support division.
Open your books to page 14. Repeat after me. No, that's what I want you to repeat. Go ahead.
Yes, it's the wonderful world of radio. Radio, where you can hear your own voice. Let the WQAM School of Broadcasting provide you with the essential tools you'll need to make your wet radio dreams come true. One come true.
And like Geldy found out, if you got an enormous schlong, it don't hurt either. It's 9 minutes before 1 at 560 WQAM. Our total over there at Cutler Ridge down at the QAM van, $810 today.
Oh!
So far, not bad. We'll get to that 1,000, won't we? Well, we better. And they're out of the Best of Neil Volume 1 on CD, but plenty on tape, plenty of cassettes, and Volume 2 on CD. I just mentioned that in passing. It's right across from Target. They're 3 blocks south of the Cutler Ridge Mall in the Publix parking lot. Look for the QAM van. Look for a guy running around like crazy trying to find somebody in a skirt. In fact, some of you guys out there, here's a mobile in Miami. Hello?
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, a couple of points for those jackasses in Congress. Lie doesn't have to be spoken to be committed, number one. And number two is how the hell do they think they all got voted into Congress?
Yeah. You mean by lying? Lying through their teeth? Yeah.
Exactly. Uh-huh. And one other thing, Ileana Ross-Lehtman, she was on TV last night talking about the timing of the bombing. I mean, if he had put a bomb...
Oh, my God.
If he put a bomb up Castro's ass, she'd have been doing the tango in the Oval Office.
That's right. If he would have done it like right on the eve of the vote on impeachment, she'd have been there sucking his butt.
Right. I mean, it's ridiculous.
Okay. See ya. Ileana Gross-Lehtman, Roseanne, Rosanna Dana in drag, man. And this is somebody in Congress, Mary Bono, she's in Congress. In fact, maybe that's one good lesson that people are getting now as they take a look at all these representatives in the House, at least most of the people in the Senate. Most of them, you know, they carry a certain aura, a certain something about them. But these House members, thank God that they get to vote them out every 2 years, because most of them are a bunch of schleppers, a bunch of schlemiels, a bunch of schmendricks. Oh, and there she is. There's Nancy Bono. Pop that bitch up for a second.
And whether sexual harassment...
Get out of here, you adulterous, phony bitch. Cut her out. Screwing around for 12 years on Sunday. No wonder he was drinking. No wonder he skied into the side of that goddamn tree and killed himself. And no wonder that all the ganze Mishpacha, including the Bull Dyke daughter there, they're all suing her ass over that will. Because she was screwing around for 12 years with who knows how many guys, and she's up there talking about sexual harassment and about this and about that. She's giving us a lesson on morality, this bitch? Who the hell are you kidding, you slut? You scumbag? You walking piece of... And she's so goddamn stupid, so idiotic, such a space cadet, an airhead. And she's up there making a speech in front of the House of Representatives like she knows what the hell she's talking about. Here's Aventura. Hello. Aventura.
Hey, hi, how are you?
Okay,
first
sir.
First time caller. How come this bitch didn't, talk bad about her husband before she was elected into the House?
Yeah, that's right. How come she wasn't talking about his drinking and all his other bullshit before she got him into the side of that tree?
Yep. Anyway, look, you're out of CD number one in Aventura Borders.
We're out of CD number one in Aventura Borders?
Yep.
Well, we better get the restocking here for these last 2 weeks.
Better, because I just got number two, but I would like to buy one. And are you, this truck coming, or this van, ever coming to Miami Beach, or?
That would be a good idea. I think next week.
Yeah, there's a lot of people that, you know.
At least five or six.
at least 5 or 6.
Okay, we'll check it out next week.
Talk to you later. Bye.
Okay, there you go. A little spy report. We're out of, see, that's right, because they're selling like hotcakes now, so we better restock one more time and get these places, what?
1,010.
Oh, my God, look at that.
They're out of part one on both CD and cassette, and they're going to be there till 1 o'clock, and then they're going to go get laid.
They're going to be there another 5 minutes, then they're going to go get laid because we got over $1,000, and Chris evidently got some numbers. $1,010, that puts us at $102,385 in anticipation of a big day at Borders and Plantation tomorrow between noon and 2 out there on West Sunrise Boulevard. 5 minutes till 1 at 560 WQM. They said it couldn't be done, boys and girls. Not only do we go over $100,000, but we're going to go, who knows, 105, 110.
Oh!
Who knows what it's going to be. Nice job, Neil. Thank you. All I can say is...
Neil, God!
And mean it when I say it. Oh, God! You know why I'm gagging?
Why, child?
Because I'm smoking a cheap, crappy cigar, that's why. Yeah, I'm smoking one of those dime store cigars. If you want to smoke a cigar that really is smooth and beautiful and puts a real smile on your face, that's a Mahia to smoke, then head for Nick Cigars. In fact, tomorrow's Saturday. Every Saturday, they know that a lot of you guys are busy during the week, working and whoring around, whatever you're doing. So they stay open on Saturdays from 11 in the morning till 4 in the afternoon, so you can come on down there and stock up on all your favorite premium cigars and accessories, etc., every Saturday or any day that you like. Nick Cigars, the largest manufacturer of great, fantastic, well-made premium hand-rolled cigars in the entire country. Right down here in our neck of the woods. I'll never forget, it's almost a year now, when we went down there with John Penis the first time and saw that place. And I said to myself, holy crap, we got a great cigar joint right here in town where they not only sell, but they make some of the finest cigars anywhere in the world. They got a wide body, wide range, rather, from full body to mild and everywhere in between. So no matter what kind of pleasure you prefer in your puss, you can probably find it. And great cigars, too, at Nick's. 7111 West Flagler Street. Just take your Flagler Street exit off the Palmetto. Go east 1 mile, and you'll be right there. Or you can call them at 305-266-9907. If you're serious about what you put in your puss, you better head for Nick's damn soon.
When Monica Lewinsky loves a great big stick, she goes down and gets it at Nick's.
Oh, boy, it's the 1 to 2 hour.
Children gather round the trucks on snowy Christmas Eve. They stand and wait for a Red Cross crate of moldy surplus cheese. It's Christmas in Bosnia, when enemies are friends.
Oh!
The only time of year when nobody winds up dead. The barbed wire fence is festooned with colorful lights, and all the rotting carcasses are brushed to the side. It's Christmas in Bosnia,
all right,
when kids come out to play. Take a nimble walk through a minefield and exchange grenades. The movement parents shooting in some big bags of meat. But you won't find Daddy's brother joining in on the feast. Cause it's Christmas in Bosnia, it's the prime result of religious cults in the armpit of the earth. And you've got yours and I've got mine. There anyway, that is Christmas in Bosnia.
Okay, 102 at 560 WQM. It's our big 1 to 2 hour. The third wave, the third attack. It's
including those flashes.
There's sirens going off again. We're bombing them into the Stone Age. Here's another one for you. Cerec disease. Here's one for you, Saddam. There you. Oh, another one. All right, so there. It's underway again. We're just bombing them back into oblivion, which is the way that everybody with a brain wants it to be, and just continuing day after day after day, month after month after month. And the best part of the news is they said the Iraqi are the military. They're just sitting back and taking it. They haven't flown one plane. They haven't done a goddamn thing. Maybe the Republican Guard over there, maybe they might all be dead for the holidays.
Oh!
All right. Maybe that's why there ain't too much going on. Because those barracks where they hang out didn't look too good on those pictures, did they? Didn't look real
no.
Not too good. Two open lines in Dade County, 5670560, pound 560 on our AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Delray Beach. Hello?
Good afternoon, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
Another great show. I suggest
we impeached Jimmy Johnson in the Dolphin running game.
Yeah? Okay, great. Okay, we have an open line at Broward 2 and Dade, 5670560. There you go. There's somebody that fits right in with WQAM. We're dropping weapons. We're dropping bombas on Baghdad. We got the Republicans trying to run a lynch mob up there in Washington, and this guy's worried about Jimmy Johnson's running game, okay? There's what's wrong with WQAM.
Oh!
I told you when I first came here 12 months ago, I told you this was the problem. Too many one-dimensional people out there in the audience who know from nothing else except round ball and football and baseball. They don't. That's it. That's all they know. And what does that say? Oh, this is Bob from Dick Insider. Hello, Bob.
Hello, Mr. Neal.
Yes, sir. Can't hear you.
I didn't call to ask anything. I didn't call to ask for anything or schlep or anything like that. Just called to wish you a merry holiday.
Well, same to you, Bob.
And I think if these so-called people that run our country keep it up, we're going to have more professional wrestlers running things.
Yeah, sounds okay to me.
Because they don't really know what they're doing at times, do they?
At times?
Well, if you hire a lawyer, you know what you're going to get, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to get lies from one end to the other end. But, yeah, I just called to wish you a good Christmas, and I've got all your CDs, and I hope to we have a... Oh, I'm glad you left that other station, by the way.
Yeah, me too.
Because you'd be getting up at 4 a.m. like our friends are.
No, I would not.
Next year.
Uh-uh.
Which I really feel sorry for them.
Okay, Bob.
All right.
Happy. Okay, say goodbye.
Howdy! Hi, I'm Spike. And you know, when I'm driving down Route 9W on a hot summer day, me and the missus always stop at Dickens Fruit Stand. They've got everything from fruit to vegetables, homemade pies, but there is nothing like their cider. Ain't that right, honey?
Uh-huh.
Dickens Cider. Yes, sir. Why, even though we were late for church last Sunday, she had to have a little Dickens Cider.
Uh-huh.
She says there ain't nothing like it. Even my minister says his wife enjoys a little Dickens Cider now and then. Hey, why don't you bring some home in our protective plastic rib bottle? That way it'll stay fresh. Or you can let it sit a while and have some hard Dickens Cider.
Uh-huh.
It's good at lunch, good at dinner, and there's nothing like waking up with a Dickens Cider. Dickens Fruit Stand, just off Route 9W and Country Road 69. Open 24 hours, because after a chilly summer night, I like to snuggle up in bed with a hot Dickens Cider.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that was Bob from Dickens Cider T-shirt fame, who's got great T-shirts. His call was a little on the, he means well. It's 5 minutes after 1 at 560 WQAM. Here's a lady in Miramar. Hello.
Yes, I was calling about the impeachment
yes,
debate.
Ma'am.
And what I was listening to it, they were talking about, I'm not Republican myself here, and I'm not really Democrat. I was an independent,
mm-hmm.
so I didn't vote for Bill Clinton. But what they had brought up here, a point was, why don't they leave it to the American people to go ahead and do vote? Which they would
do vote on what?
Well, to either go ahead and have the impeachment.
Well, because we don't have that form of government. We don't have government by plebiscite. We don't have votes
no,
on
I
issues.
I realize this here, but they could go ahead
no, they
and do
couldn't.
The censure. Yes.
Oh, yeah, though they can do
because
that, yeah.
Because it makes the Republicans...
Well, the excuse is, even though there have been four cases in American history where presidents have been censured by the Congress, they've made up this baloney about, well, it's unconstitutional and there's no specific provision for it. And as many of the Democrats have pointed out, there are lots of things that Congress does, a lot of acts that they draft, that there's no specific provision for in the Constitution, but it's not prohibited by the Constitution. They can do whatever the hell they want. If they want to censure, just like they censured Newt Gingrich, they can certainly do that to the president. But the excuse is, oh, no, we have to proceed with impeachment because that's the only remedy that we're allowed to do.
It almost makes the Republicans look like they are afraid.
Well, what do you mean almost?
I mean, it does make them look like they're afraid.
This is their last gas. Don't you understand? They just saw this last election. They see the polls. They see that no matter how much dirt they try to throw here, that the public sees through it. They don't care about his sexual peccadilloes. They do not care. They're desperate.
With all the money that's been spent on this one, we have so many other problems in this nation here.
I would take it. I would even split it with you.
Well, I'll tell you what. Oh, I'd love to split it.
Right.
Believe me.
Right down the middle.
But anyway, I was just wondering if there was a way that people could either contact somebody, whatever, to go ahead and say, put it up to the American people. Are they afraid?
No.
Not going to happen.
Oh, no, I know because they're in power. But I'll tell you what. they'll sure in hell get out of power
That's
very quickly.
That's right. The Y2K
because
problem.
Because I'll tell
you
what, when they're doing this here, they're doing nothing but turning the American people against
Amen.
The
okay,
Republican
sweetheart.
Party.
Have a great holiday.
Okay,
just say
you.
No to the fascists. Okay. That's what Nancy Reagan said. Just say
no
to those fascists like Bob Barr and all the rest of those goyim. We have an open line in Broward. See, that's the I've told you a long time ago. When you have too many goyim in the Congress, you got real problems, baby. Here's Miami. Hello.
Boca Bryan stinks, and I don't.
Yeah, oh, yeah, there you go. There's your buddy. There's your buddy. That's Boca Bryan. It's, you know, send him one of those blow-up dolls we got, okay, and keep him busy. Boca Bryan is God.
Oh!
Okay, you jackass. You little simpleton. You weasel with no material. Pathetic. In fact, I'm going to play Boca Bryan all the rest of the hour just to piss him off, okay? Just so he can go into the corner there, stick his thumb in his mouth and his finger in his
rectum,
have a good time with himself, okay? Maniac. One, another one, no, Charlie. In fact, give him Andy from Hollywood's home phone number, and the two of them can diddle each other. 9 minutes after one at 560. Hey, Andy, if you want to take it personally, please. And if you don't want to take it personally, do it anyway, okay? I don't want to see you.
No.
I don't want to talk to you.
No.
I don't want your faxes.
No.
I don't want your phone calls.
No.
I don't want to hear from your again.
No.
Your girlfriend, she's very nice. Do I want to see her?
No.
Just everybody, just find a new hobby, okay? In fact, you and this guy would get along great. 109 at 560 WQAM, your sports neurosis station for the 90s. Even when nuclear bombs are dropping in your backyard, it's still, do the Dolphins have a running game?
No.
Is always the answer, by the way.
Nunca eches el papel en el toile porque se tupe.
I thought Christianity was fairy tale.
Boy!
This religious thing was not for me. They held a big convention, lesbian for free. Had no idea what I was about to see.
Oh!
They were speaking in tongues. That made me a believer. It was kind of fun to stick it out of my mouth. Speak in tongues. They got me believing, my conscience breathing from side to side. The Lord will now embrace me. I clap my tongue to the beat. Now, whatever I do, he'll forgive me.
Oh!
Cause now I speak in tongues. That makes me a believer. And I'm having fun. Playing around with my mouth. Now I speak in tongues.
The great vocal prize, another award winner, a 10-star number. It's 115 at 560 WQM. As a matter of fact, Joe Kennedy is up there speaking now from Massachusetts, who says if anybody's family knows about screwing around.
He said
right there at the end, he said just before he finished and started talking about food stamps for the Kennedys, he said, hey, if things should happen and the president should wind up being forced to resign or being convicted and et cetera and so on, then Al Gore becomes president. I say Boca Bryan for vice president.
Oh!
That's what Joe Kennedy just said.
Our school.
Here's Kendall. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
Question for you.
Yes.
I listen to you about once or twice a week, and I enjoy your show pretty much. I got a question for you, though.
Yeah.
I was primarily raised Catholic and so forth. You know, I think I have a decent.
Boy.
I think I have a decent belief system, but I do. I agree.
What does that mean? A decent belief system?
I'm pretty happy with the way I think.
Are you
sufficiently
superstitious? Is that what that means?
No. Let me. I agree with you in most.
There's
of your
no fact in the church.
Yeah.
I agree with you in that. You know, as long as you're a good person and morally...
DNH, baby, do no harm. It's very simple. That's all you need to know. Anything beyond that is complicated life.
I agree with you there, but let me say this in return. Let me argue with you a little bit.
Argue about
what? Well, let me say this. I agree with you in that. If you're a good person, I don't care what religion you are, Buddhist, whatever, if there's a supreme being, you'll be safe. Fine. Who cares?
There is no supreme being.
Okay, but let's...
There's only...
Neil, God!
That's as close as it gets to supreme being.
Neil, let me say this.
There's Diana Ross. That's a supreme being.
Most people, you don't have a problem with the smoking weed. Neither do I, or doing things, whatever they want to do.
Smoking weed, what does that have to do with religion?
Well, my point is this. If it makes them feel good, why not just leave them alone? I mean, I'm on your side, but why not leave them alone? If it, for 1%, helps one person and it makes them feel good, who cares? If it makes them feel good...
What makes them feel good?
If it's not...
What are you talking about?
Okay, if they have a belief system, and they annoy me or they annoy you, okay?
Wait a minute. Who's taking it away from them? I don't care. I'm just expressing my opinion. That's all. The only difference being if they want to use it as a weapon against other people, then I got a real problem with it.
Okay, that's
if they want to use it to spread their bigotry and narrow-mindedness and intolerance, if that makes them feel good, too bad.
I agree with you. That is a problem. But the problem is not people who believe it and don't
and
do
in
that.
Addition to which, in America, we don't have very many of those people who just practice their own superstitions. Most people who are the more religious they claim to be in this country, the more intolerant they are and the more hatred they spread.
So what you're saying is if somebody were superstitious and had a belief, as long as it didn't bother other people, it'd be all right with you?
Of course.
Okay. All right. I didn't know that. I didn't...
Like most of my experiences in Europe, I don't find religious fanaticism too much of it over there, except in Northern Ireland. I've never been there and I wouldn't go.
So you really don't believe religion in a whole is completely horrible as long as you're not a fanatic and bother other people.
And as long as you're not being fleeced of money by a bunch of charlatans and fakers, which is happening all the time.
Right. As long as you keep it to yourself.
And as long as it doesn't cost you any money. When it starts costing you money, then you know you're being ripped off.
Yeah, that's a problem. But as long as you don't bother other people, you keep it to yourself, that's fine.
Right.
Whatever makes you happy. If you feel like smoking weed,
yeah.
You feel happy, fine.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, I agree with you. I just don't agree with you when you're putting down something that...
Like what?
You know, men can corrupt anything. I agree with you there. Men will corrupt anything. Business, whatever endeavor they put their hand on, they're gonna screw it up eventually.
Well, what does that mean?
Well, what I'm saying is... You know, don't blame...
Are you saying that all those people that died in the Spanish Inquisition and the Crusades,
that was men screwing up.
I see. It's always man's fault. Right.
Well, whose fault can it be?
Religions don't kill
no
people. Men kill
no
people. That's the new bumper. Okay, God bless you, sir. Have a great honor.
God invented religion.
What is it? No, man didn't invent religion. What? Are you some kind of a heathen atheist bastard?
Uh-huh.
What the hell's wrong with you, man? Don't you remember God handed those 5 tablets to Abraham Solomon? Not to Moses. It was Abraham Solomon. And he said,
oy.
Who the hell's going to believe this crap? He said, well, why not give it a shot? That's what he said. I mean, if God was Jewish, I mean, what's all this other Geiser stuff about anyway? See, that's where the Goyim made their worst mistake, is they accepted the Jewish God. You got to invent your own God. Now, Jesus, he's, part of the Mishpacha, but you have to have your own God. If you're not strong enough to invent your own God, at least the Buddhists, huh? All these other, those are cults. Yeah, right. Why is he getting me started on this crap? Okay, in fact, look at those Iranians over there. Do you hear Iraqis, rather? Same difference. You hear all that wailing going on when they start with that prayer crap early in the morning? They got Christia Amanpour standing over there. The bombs are bursting in there in the background. They're going, like that. Just like the Orthodox Jews there at the wailing wall. Great. Pretty embarrassing, okay? Very embarrassing behavior, just like what we're watching right now in the House of the United States. Embarrassing behavior by a bunch of hypocritical, phony, baloney people who say, don't do as I say, don't do as I do, whatever, however that goes. Who just mouth a lot of bullcrap, even though they don't believe it themselves, even though they're a bunch of compulsive liars, even though they're most of them a bunch of whoremongers. All of a sudden, they're sanctimonious. I told you this months ago, sanctimonious, hypocritical, goody-two-shoes. The people in the Congress, the people in the media, most people in America, because they can't face up to the fact that people are horny, they like screwing around, and it's nobody's goddamn business. Here's Margate. Hello.
Yes, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, with what Trent Watt said yesterday about no compromise, if the Democrats had any balls, they would stand up as a block of 45 and force a censure.
And how can they do that?
It'd be very easy. If at least 34 Democrats say right off the bat that they would vote not guilty, that forces a censure. It'd be very easy to end this whole thing if they would just stand together at any time. This trial can end at any time. It's 51.
Well, we don't have a trial yet.
No, but I mean before the trial, when they're doing motions and so forth, motions for this, motions for that.
Yeah.
All they got to do is stand up as a block and say we will not find this guy guilty, and then they would force.
But that's not how it works. I mean, I don't know all the parliamentary maneuvers and procedures, that's not going to happen.
You're going to see that. It's going to take about 3 months for the trial to even get underway because there's going to be a lot of motions back and forth.
Yeah.
And this will be easy to end.
That was what started all this. Too many motions back and forth. Okay. We have an open line in Dade 1 in Broward, 567-0560. That's right, it wasn't the apple on the tree, it was the pear on the ground, baby.
Oh!
That's what starts all the problems. It was the bitch on her knees. Here's South Miami. Hello. How come we don't impeach Monica Lewinsky? South Miami.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Oh, Lord, Father. Hey, I was going to make a quick phone call to you, but, man...
Oh, God!
Yeah, after holding for a long... The first time I listened to you is when...
17 minutes and 10 seconds, not that bad.
The first time I listened to you, just reminiscing, is that when the Persian Gulf War first started out back in the early 90s.
91, yeah.
Yeah, I was listening to you while I was working it back, and I said, my God, it's such a long time now.
I know. Seems like only yesterday we were doing the same crap.
I know. What I call to say is, remember the Republican who says, read my lips?
Yeah.
No new taxes.
Right, he didn't lie to the public, did he?
And on national TV.
Right.
Well, Lord God, I have to go back to work.
And God bless you.
Your servant beseech you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Okay. We have an open line. See, I like a lot more guys like him, subservient and obedient. Open line in Dade, 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. How about those hockey tickets, by the way? Here's Plantation. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
Happy Hanukkah.
What is it? I can't hear you. I crank this poor guy up. What is it?
Happy Hanukkah.
Oh, Happy Chinookah, yes. Happy Yarmulke.
Okay. I just had my ham sandwich, and I'm Jewish, but I don't care.
How, a little cheese on there, too?
No, just mustard.
Come on, ham and cheese.
I don't
put
like
some
cheese.
Mayonnaise on there, like those Goyim do in Amsterdam on their fries.
No, no, no. It's too fat for me.
Mm-hmm. Like they say at the Sunset, and it'll hold the mayo.
Yep, I held the mayo and just had a plane. Listen, I don't usually talk about politics, but yesterday when I heard about this Livingstein guy admitting to his affairs...
Affairs plural, that's right. We don't know how many yet. We don't know, but he says several, like 20 or 30, 40,
yeah.
50, 100, 200. He screwed everything with a skirt on,
and you see
including the Pope.
You see the... Ooh, the Pope, too.
Mm-hmm.
See the picture of him on TV that they show with that weird grin on his face.
Yeah.
But, you know, when he announced that he did have these affairs, he started off using a line from the Gettysburg Address. 4 scores, 7 years ago.
Right. He scored 4 times.
At least.
7 hours.
I'm just so outraged. I think they're all a bunch of hypocrites. I never knew what the word
Here
was.
We got Henry Hyde up there, the cheerleader, the ringleader up there this morning. We got their new speaker designated of the House, Bob Livingston from Louisiana, who's screwing everything with a dress on. We got Dan Coats from Indiana, who fathered an illegitimate child, tried to cover that up. We got Mary Bono, who's been screwing around with everything with a penis attached to it. And these people are up there passing judgment because the president likes getting his rocks off.
Every Republican.
And won't fess up to it.
Every Republican they bring forward has got some kind of dirt all over them.
Right, that's right. You can smell it. In fact, this is the first time we ever have smell-o-vision. When they come on the screen, the stench of it comes right through your TV set.
Unbelievable. They ought to get Ken Starr to investigate this guy with an independent counsel and ask him real personal questions about all his affairs.
No, what we ought to do is investigate Ken Starr. That's what we ought to do. And find out how many blow-up dolls he's got in the closet.
God only knows what he's into.
Right, exactly. I
don't
be surprised if
it.
He likes to dress up like J. Edgar Hoover.
His face is like a cabbage patch. I don't know what.
He looks like a cabbage snatch doll.
He should be hit with a baseball bat.
Okay, well, we'll work on it. Have a great life. Okay, let's get Joe DiMaggio out of the hospital one last time, if anybody's got good aim. Joe DiMaggio, let's see if Joe's got enough strength to hit Ken Starr just one time. Come on, Joe.
Ouch!
All right, good shot. He still hasn't lost it. Anyway, it's 1:25 at QM. We got Hank standing by. He'll be along at 2:00. We got the Booster at 6:00, and then we got Ed Kaplan tonight with a compulsive gambling show for those people that even during impeachments and wars can't stop their compulsive gambling problems. But it is a good diversionary thing. You know what I'm talking about?
Neil God.
Hello again, everyone, from the Channel 7 News Center. I'm Rick Sanchez with your 60-second Gulf War update. We have some new reports that just came in. They're hard to explain, so let's move to the Middle East war map. Rick's World, if you will, and I'll try to explain.
Rick's World, party on, excellent.
Party on, everyone. I'm your most excellent anchor, Rick Sanchez, and with me, as always, Sally Fitz. Party on, Sal.
Party on, Rick. Called San Pedro lately?
Not since I've been back from Houston. People in the business remember, but fortunately for me, the public has a short memory.
Say, what about that guy you flattened? Is he still in a coma?
Yeah, still in a coma. I'm so glad you brought that up, Sal. Not. Anyway, Hussein blew off a couple more scuds at the occupied West Bank, but those awesome Patriot dudes intercepted.
Kaboom! Kaboom!
As you know, the insane Hussein... Gosh, can I turn an original phrase or what? He has poison gas, but as I squat... over Baghdad.
Gas mask alert.
I'll give him a gas of my own.
Hot air out of both ends.
Hussein today said,
yeah, look at the...
I do not know the secret weapon the Americans have. The 40-foot colossal news anchor with the chapped lips squatting over my country with the smelly gas. My troops are all fleeing, but for me, I ran. but I couldn't hide.
Well, that's all the time we have for today. Party on, Sal.
Party on, Rick.
I'll sit and squat, so you worry not. Rick over Iraq for Channel 7 News.
Okay, 131 at 560 WQM. Bluff Lindsay, our program director, just stuck his head in the door and said...
It puts the lotion in the basket.
Okay, where are we going? Let's go to Miami. Hello.
Yeah, hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing today?
Great. Never been better, sir.
My first question is, can I be in love with you even though I'm a heterosexual?
No, thanks.
No, thanks?
Only at the foot of my altar.
Neil, God!
Yes. Next question.
Okay. Next question is, did you notice a guy that called earlier who said he had just finished buying your CDs or cassettes?
Right.
And then he said, oh, can I get a request? And he requested something that was on the CD or cassette.
Well, it's more fun hearing it over the radio, I guess.
I bet.
Or maybe he can't afford a CD player yet.
Yeah, maybe he's driving on 441 and he can't hear the signal
that
at all.
That could be it, right.
So that was...
we're doing pretty damn well, considering that most of the time you can't hear the damn station. We're doing pretty good.
That is beautiful. I like the fuzz. It sounds great.
Yeah. It fits right in.
The other thing is, I always hear you call black people Schwarzers.
Yeah.
And I was wondering, we used to always call them Regins. And I was wondering if you'd ever find a liking to that.
Call black people what?
Regins.
What the hell is that?
Well, spell it backwards.
Regins? Oh, no, that was supposed to be clever. That was like niggers backward, is that it? That was very cute, sir. That was brilliant. He went through all of that song and a dance to get to that. That was very cute. Okay, we have an open line in Dade, 567-0560, pound 560. What can we say about that guy?
He's an asshole.
Here's Boca Bryan, by the way, who came in today special just so we can meet up with his number one fan, who called in before. He said, holiday greetings to my close personal friend Boca Bryan. He's the best in the world. Is that what the guy said before?
No.
Guy's just jealous, okay? He wishes he had all that hair. So what was this guy saying about something about, oh, nigger toes? By the way, have you ever heard that expression, nigger toes? No, it's a certain kind of nut. What kind of nuts does that refer to? They call them nigger toes. Nuts.
Brazil nuts?
That might be it. Have you ever used that expression, nigger toes? Anyway, why is everybody looking at me like I just made that up? There's such a thing.
Not past the age of 10.
Oh.
But yes, little kids do that.
Well, there you go. Little kids call those dark nuts. Here's Plantation. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How are you?
Okay, sir.
Did you happen to hear about the comment that Alec Baldwin made?
About
Henry Hyde?
Somebody said yesterday, but my convenient Alzheimer's
picked
up.
It was about the fact that he should be sent back overseas, like to Israel or somewhere, where he would be stoned and he should die. And then he got all kinds of negative flack from people because he said it.
Why is that?
That's what I was wondering.
Well, first of all, the Israelis don't want him. He ain't Jewish. I mean, he's as goyish as they come.
Well, the comment...
Maybe Syria would be good.
Well, he wished...
Or maybe France would be good. He'd fit in like a rubber glove there.
Well, you know, the thing is that he's wishing Henry Hyde what he deserves.
Yeah.
And he's being criticized for it.
Well, I say Alec Baldwin for emperor.
Oh!
That's what I say. We have an open line in Broward, 56705. You know, when you're a sanctimonious hypocrite, I mean, if you're a pervert, you like wave the flag like I do. Hey, pervert here, and I'm proud of it. Proud pervert, PP. Proud of the PP, proud pervert, even if it is small. But when you start like with this holier than thou, and oh my God, he lied to the public, and he lied to his cabinet, and he purged it. About what? About what? About getting blowjobs? You take that out of the equation, you take the blue dress with a stain on it, and you have nothing. You have $55 million of taxpayer money flushed right down the toilet is what you've got. Nothing. Zippity-doo-dah. And isn't it, what an amazing coincidence. That just suddenly there was some new smoking gun or some new smoking penis that they discovered here, that all these so-called moderates and all these wavering Republicans all of a sudden came to the same conclusion, like we just found some damaging smoking member or something. Was there any such thing?
No.
No, but just overnight. One by one, they fell into line. They goose-stepped right into line there. As though somebody were pulling the strings, like they were like little puppets, marionettes on the end of that string. I think we better get Luca Brasi on a goddamn phone. Here's Davey. Hello.
Uncle Neil.
Yes, sir.
You know, Slick Willie screwed up just because he lied. It almost doesn't matter, you know, what it was about. But
like Bush said, no new taxes, and he didn't lie, and Gingrich didn't lie under oath, by the way, yeah.
It's to the grand jury. I mean, you know, there's a higher level. You're smart
so what difference does it make?
You're smart enough to know that.
Yeah. And what difference does it make? Is that an impeachable offense? I'm smart enough to know that? Is that an offense against the government? Does that endanger the government of this country? They lied about his sexual peccadilloes?
I think people have definitely been after this guy for a while, and this is where he screwed up. I mean, it's definitely going to be, whether he's thrown out of office or not, it's just not going to look good for him just by being impeached. And a lot of, you know,
what does that mean? It's not going to look good for him. What does that mean?
Well, because, you know, he walks around on television and everything like he's the king of the United States of America.
Does he really? Based on what? When did he do that? It looks to me like he's aged about 20 years in the last 10 or 12 months, based on the last time I saw him, as in yesterday. Looks to me like he's aging very ungracefully, by the way, and under tremendous stress and duress. And in the meantime, he was over there in Israel like he promised them at the Gaza, doing this thing to try to salvage that Middle East peace thing. And he, you know, is doing this thing over there, bombing them into the Stone Age and doing every day what he's supposed to be doing, which is what he's elected to do. See, guys like this, they don't confuse them with the facts, okay, because this guy gets sucked into all this rhetoric. Oh, he lied under oath. Well, you know something? So what? Like Henry Hyde this morning said, the so what defense, and that's what the majority of people would tell you, so what? We don't care. And they can't stand that. The Republicans can't deal with that. So what? Did he lie about anything that had anything to do with the operation of the United States government?
No.
No, absolutely not. He did what any other rational person, especially a person in a position of prominence, would do. I mean, for crying out loud, the goddamn president, he was hoping that somebody had a brain. That some dumb bitch had a goddamn brain and wouldn't start yapping on a goddamn phone with illegally recorded phone conversations, which we're not supposed to be concerned about that, about the illegalities there with Linda Tripp. We're not supposed to be concerned about the illegalities with the leaks from Kenneth Starr or the illegal contacts with Paula Jones' lawyers. We just wash all of that in the background and talk about this brilliant referral from Judge Starr, who we know never stole a freight train, and that's the best we can say for him. Because we know for certain that he was nonpartisan. Oh, yeah. 22 before 2 at 560 WQAM.
My God, is that thing real?
Banana picking Julios who thrive on anarchy are building an arena for the Miami Heat. Having two arenas somehow don't seem right. Better ask Jeff Owen for financial advice.
NBA is locked down, there's no basketball, they're all on strike. Let's burn the place down, an insurance check would sure be nice.
Before we lose our ass, take a can of gas.
Oh!
Like that nut.
Award-winning Volker Bryan, a genius if there ever was one. And to show you what a genius he is, by the way. Look what he brings in today, boys and girls. A little scratchy in the record, too. Monica, are you listening, you disgusting old chappy bitch, huh, you fat cow?
Quirk, quirk.
You hear that? Look at Monica, he said. You hear that? This is a bunch of hooey. I love it. Okay, Mitch Ryder, the Detroit Wheels. Better late than ever. Devil with a blue dress on. That's what it's all about. Here's that Bill McCollum from Florida. Howdy doody with glasses, okay? Real asshole. If they're, you know what they say about him, don't you?
He's an asshole.
That's right.
On the witness.
Get him out of here. Makes me want to vomit. Devil with a blue dress on, with a stained dress. That's what America, and that's why the rest of the world is looking at us like laughing and scratching their head and their ass, wondering what the hell's going on over here.
It's not going to look very good, though, on his record, on his resume.
That guy was a genius. Make no mistake about it. Kill it. Okay, where are we going? Here's North Miami Beach. Hello.
Hello.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, Neil. I just tuned on your radio a while ago. I heard you mention Mickey Rourke.
Okay, we have an open line and date, 5670560#5. I wonder how long it would take to get her out of the closet, you know? Is that pathetic or is that pathetic, huh? Jesus Christ.
I've got a lot of friends that are on the police force here that in confidentiality have told me how much of an asshole Prince is.
Which is probably why I changed his name. Here's a mobile. Hello. In somewhere. What is it? Well, no wonder he didn't tell you where he was because he's too stupid to figure it out. Okay, an open line and date, 5670560 and #560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Man, what's with that bitch that keeps calling about Mickey Rourke, huh?
Well, who knows? She's got her blow-up doll there. She's blowing it.
Negative on the life scale, man.
Yeah.
I guess they're going to remember...
about 82 points.
I guess they're going to remember this as a nitpicking 90s, where we just nitpicked about everything in everybody's lives.
I'll tell you one thing. It's a lot healthier to nose-pick than it is to nitpick, as long as you got your nails trimmed.
I reckon so, Yonder.
Right.
But, you know...
How do you like this Bill McCollum, man? I'm embarrassed that he's...
I don't like him at all. You know? But, we have got our priorities all screwed up here.
Yeah.
There's many more important things that we should be concentrating on.
I wonder how many dresses he stained in his pathetic existence.
I mean, we got a big game on Monday night here.
Right, that's
and,
right.
And we need to bring back
about
the brains
crap.
Down.
That's right, and you got your goddamn gator meat, too, so go beat it. We have an open line and date, 5670561 in Broward and the #560 on the AT&T wireless line. Wait till after 2 o'clock, okay? No more sports nerds till after 2. Here's Coral Springs. Hello.
Oh, Uncle Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing today?
Okay.
I just want to say, I picked up both your CDs, Volume 1 and 2, and they're both excellent.
Thank you.
Especially Volume 1.
Especially.
And I like to say, if there's any way you can get on, stop bombing Iraq today, any way you can get that on.
Okay, you got it.
Thank you.
In fact, thanks for reminding me, as a matter of fact.
Thanks.
Okay. They're doing it right now, by the way. They're dropping La Bamba. They're dropping a big one. Anybody else ever drop a big one?
Thought bombing Baghdad, do it every day.
Okay.
I want to watch it on TV. Iraq, Iraq. We've nothing to lose. It should take a day. Let us just put an end to it. Iraq, Iraq. I want to wake up and see their cities don't exist. Puff in thin air and tell that Saddam Hussein we're really pissed. You're under my skin, that little piece of sh. Ain't getting away. I'll get the mob to make a hit from old New York. Saddam has got to go off that now. We all know it's time to bomb Iraq, Iraq.
All right.
Their cities are blown to bits, a bluey, baby, and say that we're number one, top of the heat.
Oh,
we can't be beat. Again, we have won. Stop bombing Iraq. Why not start today? Let's make a parking lot of it.
Oh!
That old Iraq.
Okay.
And when all the boys are there, I'll do a show with that chick chair and say goodbye, Iraq, Iraq, Iraq.
Total seven heads. Bang, bang, you're dead. Ouch.
Okay, 150 to 560. You never know when that damn thing is over, you know what?
It puts the lotion in the basket.
10 till 2 at 560 WQAM, your sports neurotic station for the 90s.